Okay, assalamualaikum and a very good morning to all the students, the new students and also the existing students of Imbiases. Everyone, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yes.
All right. Okay. So because our schedule should be started at 9:30 and now it's 9:34. So first of all, I would like to introduce myself. I am Dr. Nurkhalidah Kamal, the course coordinator for RBRB 6014. And also we have Dr. Kamarul Azlan, the course coordinator for RBRB 8014. Basically, 6014 is for master students, while 8014 is for PhD students. However, the class will be done at the same time, all right? So today basically is a briefing or an introduction on the Imbiases. So I think without further ado, I would like to welcome our director, Dr. Sharul Natakain, for the first session.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Wait.
We cannot see you.
Wait.
Yeah, we cannot see you.
How to make me see? Wait. How to set? Wait. Wait. Okay, stop to I don't know why you cannot see me. I also cannot see myself. Yeah.
All right, we can see you now, Dr. Ain.
Okay. Okay, just the integrated camera. Okay, now I know. Okay, sorry for that technical error. So, okay, I'll just start. Okay, so let me share the slide. I cannot share content. Can you make me host? Talida, can you make me host?
Cari doktor, saya pun tengah mencari.
Okay, okay, now dah okay. Okay.
Alright, okay.
Okay, okay. Let me share the slide. Okay. 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 So, first of all, I would like to welcome all the new students of Imbisis. So, welcome to Imbisis. I hope you we have a very enjoyable journey, fruitful journey during your stay at Imbisis for maybe 2 years, 3 years, or I hope not more than 4 years. Okay. So, we are targeting for the GOT for all of the students. Okay. So, first slide, already talk about the GOT. Okay. So, okay. First, I would like to introduce to you about what is Imbisis is all about. I hope that you know that Imbisis is Institute of System Biology, Institute Biology System in Malay. Okay, so then known as Imbisis. Okay, so Imbisis is a center of excellence. Okay, a reference and also a training center for modern biotechnology research. So we seek holistic understanding of the biological complexity and designed to provide a dynamic infrastructure and environment. So I'm sure that the seniors, the one that already have that already at Imbisis right now, so you already have seen our facility, our building, our small building, okay? But I think it's enough for us to do our research on the system biology, okay? So, for your information, Imbisis born on 25th of March in 2005, okay? So, we should celebrating our 20 years anniversary, okay? Next, maybe in 3 years time, okay? So, under Imbisis, we have three centers, okay? Center for Genome Analysis and Technology, or we call it CGAT. Okay, Center for Plant Biotechnology or CPB, and Center for Bioinformatics Research, which is CBR. Okay, so you can see the building around us. Okay, so mainly the center of the CGAT and also CBR is under the same building, the main building of Imbisis. Okay, however, the Center for Plant Biotechnology are located outside of the main building. So that one is sharing facility with the Faculty of Science and Technology. Okay, you can see the complex rumah tumbuhan. Okay, that one is our Center for Plant Biotechnology, Plant Biotech. Okay, so some of you are doing research on plant biotech, basically on the tissue culture type of study. You will be located there at the Center for Plant Biotech near the rumah tumbuhan, okay, complex rumah tumbuhan, okay. So under these three centers, we aim actually what we are focusing on that different center have their own specialty, okay, they have their own strength, okay. So for example, for CGAT, this is a research center for the main, mostly on the study on the omics, okay, covering on the genomics, proteomic, metabolomic technology, okay. So this is the main center, I would say, okay. And then we have the plant biotech center, okay, which is focusing mostly on the plant study, okay, and on the plant biotech, okay. So study on the different type of plant fruits, okay, the foods, okay, and also study on the secondary metabolites. And then for the CBR, focusing on the computational study, okay. So for the large data, okay, large scale of data set, okay, the analysis, as you know that when you're working on the omics, the data will be very huge, okay, a lot of data need to be analyzed. So this is the job of the bioinformatics research, okay. So in order for us to have the understanding on the biological system. Okay, the mission of Imbisis, an outstanding institute pursuing research in system biology benefiting mankind, and our mission, unravel biological processes and networks leading towards exciting discovery. Okay, so this is our educational goals, very long. Okay, there are two educational goals, okay, to bring together highly qualified independent researchers to investigate highly complex biological processes and network in the best way possible in interdependence, interdisciplinary teams, okay, interdependent and also interdisciplinary. Okay, so we have the crosstalk between different fields, different study, okay, different expertise in our one roof, okay, to serve as a supporting venue for researcher in interdisciplinary teams as they learn how to talk disciplinary border, language and traditions, okay. So in under this one small roof, we talk to each other, different field, different different expertise. I think that is the unique about the Imbisis, okay. So we have many experts from different field, different omics, okay. Then we talk together, we do collaborate together in the same same kind of big project. So we integrate all the informations, all the data, all the expert in one study on in one project, okay. That's the idea of Imbisis, okay. Okay, so this is about how to empowering teaching learning in high impact. Okay, so we are talking about high impact research, high impact innovation, high quality paper, high quality research, and high quality researcher. Okay, all this is our aim. Is we would like to see this happen at Imbisis actually. Okay. So the quality impactful research, okay, empowering the frontier research, okay, expertise and research contribute to the economic and social development. Okay, we also need to address the issue on the social, on the economic impact, okay, on the Malaysia ecosystem. We need to address all these the issues by using our research and knowledge, okay. So graduates from the national aspiration, okay, competitive, innovative, okay. So UKM graduate with the national aspiration, okay. This is like what we call it, the Jiwa Watan, okay, or the national aspiration, okay, with the ethical values, knowledgeable, competence, innovative and competitive in the meeting that needs of the country and also the global international community. Okay, so the main focus of area molecular exploration of the tropical biodiversity, okay, sustainable for discovery of the new genes and biomolecules, application of transgenic technologies for crop improvement and production of the new biomolecules. I'm sure every one of us working on this aspect, okay. It doesn't mind you working in a microbial, in a plant, in a maybe aqua culture, okay, but all these are the main research area that we're expecting from Imbisis, okay, to discover a new genes, new biomolecules and exploration of the biodiversity and so on. Okay, this is the main research focus, okay. So we have the biological application of the local biodiversity. We also working on the fronting national food security. As we know nowadays is the food safety and food security is the main agenda of Malaysia. So because of the not enough food, okay. So this is the main agenda, okay. We need to bring it, bring this agenda through Imbisis, okay. That's why we have study on different type of plant for food, okay. For example, we have study on rice, okay, led by Prof. Zamri, and then study on the grouper fish, okay, led by me, okay, and also the papaya study, Dr. Goh and Dr. Hamidun, and giant prawn by Dr. Low. Okay, we also have a study on the local biodiversity, which is focusing on the herbal plants. Okay, we have many herbal plants that you can see in our plots. Later on, I will show you our plots. Okay, so mainly when we start the big research at Imbisis at that time, we are focusing on the kersom. Okay, kesum. Okay, it's a polygonal minus. So we are still working on it. Some of us still working on it. I'm still working on it actually. Okay, and also later, then once we have the integrate all the system biology approach in a kesum. Okay, so later on we study a different. Then we use this information, this technologies, the integration. Or mix, then we use this, we apply this to other plant as well. Okay, so we also working on the ketum, okay, kratom, okay, ketum, you know ketum, very controversial plants, okay, but they have a lot of benefit actually, okay, and then we also study on mangosteen have been done many, many years ago by Prof. Norma, our Professor Emeritus, the founding director of Imbisis, okay. And then on the pitcher plant as well. So this study has been done many, many years. Now it's continued by mangosteen continued by Dr. Aizad and pitcher plant continued by Dr. Goh. Okay. And then other study as well. For example, the study on the disease. Okay. So on the oil palm disease, we know that our crop, okay, there's a lot of economic value of our crop on the oil palm. Okay, we study also on this and also on the cocoa disease, okay, and also on the aquaculture disease. Okay, all this been done in at Imbisis. Okay. So for the in order for us to address or to answer the United Nations and the Sustainable Development Goals SDG, okay, so we know that we have 17 SDG, right? Okay, so we at Imbisis, we are focusing at different type of SDG. For example, zero hunger, good health and well-being, life below water, and life on land. Okay, maybe others SDG also can be included at Imbisis research area. Okay, so I'd like to talk, I would like to share with you, to show to you how a human resource at Imbisis. Okay, so we have the management, okay, we have the management team, I'm a director, okay, and then we have a deputy director, Associate Prof. Dr. Goh Ho Han, and then we have the head of CGAD and head of CPB, okay, Associate Prof. Dr. Ng Chan Leong, and then head of CBR, Dr. Noor Azlan Noor Muhammad, head of quality assurance, Dr. Kamrul Azlan Azizan, and under that we have many coordinators, okay, which is we have the postgraduate coordinator, Dr. Noor Khalida, okay, she's the one that we involve a lot with all of the students actually, especially on the activities, okay, so we talk about the persatuan, okay, the association later, okay, and then we have the lab coordinator, okay, Dr. Low, research plot coordinator Dr. Imelda, promotion coordinator Dr. Ahmad Bazli, and then we have the CODA coordinator Dr. Sarah Hani, and then we have the international collaboration, industry collaboration coordinator Dr. Maizom, Associate Professor Dr. Maizom, and ISO coordinator still by under Dr. Kamaru Azlan, okay, and then we have the webinar coordinator Dr. Muni, and we have the research coordinator which is Dr. Hamizah, okay, so you will know all these fellow, the academic staff at Imbisis, okay, so we also have the lab management staff, okay, under Dr. Low, okay, all the staff, I'm sure all of you know this staff, they are very important person because they are the one that you will see every day in the lab, okay, they are the one that manage the lab, okay, manage the instruments, okay, manage the plot and so on, so you see all of them in the lab, okay, very often, okay. So we have different platform, metabolomics, genomics, proteomics, bioinformatics, and the RT-PCR2, the transgenic house, okay, and then we have that the lab at the CPB and also the plot, okay, so all this then we have the lab for the services, okay, chemical analysis, okay, and others that involve in your in autoclaving your things, okay, and then the one that you ask for the chemicals, the one that you ask for the consumable and pipette tip, and so on, okay, you can go and see them, Okay, please be nice to them. They will be nice to you. Okay, that's the tips. Okay. Okay, so we have the Imbiasis academic staff. Okay, so all of us are here. Okay, we are your supervisor. Okay, some of us are your main supervisors, some of us your co-supervisors, but we are your supervisors. Most of the students might have the same fellows. Okay, so because we are sharing, and also as I said, we are integrating our research. Okay, that's why you will have one fellow in metabolomic, one fellow in proteomic, depend on the expert in your projects. Okay. So all of these academic staff and biases. So as for now, we have 17 permanent research fellow, okay, which is the main in biases. We are the permanent here, or hakiki at in biases. Okay, we have 17 of us, and then the others is dual appointment, which is from the Faculty of Science and Technology. Okay. So as you know that you are in our program now, because you already register, okay, you'll be facing us for many years, okay, 2 years, 3 years, and four, maybe 4 years, okay, hopefully not more than that, okay. So we have the Master of Science in System Biology and Doctor of Philosophy, which is in the System Biology as well. So this is only two courses that we have at Imbiasis at the moment, okay. So I hope that you are registered to the right course. If you are not registered to these courses, maybe you are in the different faculty. Okay, please check. Okay, I hope that you are at Imbiasis. Okay, you are Imbiasis student. Okay, so we have the facility at Imbiasis. Some of you that already at Imbiasis now, you can see these facilities yourself. But the one still online, the one that still at their country, you will come to Malaysia, you come to UKM maybe next semester, because the next semester will be compulsory for all the students to be physically doing research, okay, and also teaching and research, okay, physically next semester. Okay, so we give this is what we call it transition time. Okay, so we still have the hybrid session. Okay, meaning that's the one that at Imbiasis you can do physical teaching and learning, but the one that still at their own country, they can do that hybrid by using the online platform. Okay, I hope that you will check your country, because there's some country have some restriction, I know that. So please check that. I hope that all of you that still online overseas, make sure you have access to all of our teaching and learning materials. Please make sure of that. Okay, so we don't want to have any problem during your study here, because you already register and already pay for the tuition fee, right? So we don't want you to lose somewhere. Okay, you're missing in action, and you don't get access to the system. Okay, the UKM folio is very important. All the information we share in the UKM iFolio system, just make sure that you have access to the system. Okay. Okay, so facility at Imbiasis, we have the metabolomics lab. So we have all the high-end instrument, very expensive instrument. So that's why, because of these expensive instruments, we are not allowed the student to hands-on themselves. So we have the person in charge, we have the staff, the science officer and research officer that will help you to run your sample, and then they give you the raw data, and then you do the interpretation by yourself. Okay. So we that one also, metabolomics lab also open for services. We have the analytical service lab, okay, and also for the proteomic also we open for the services. Okay, so we have the genomic and transcriptomic lab. Okay, so all this is the general or the normal facility, the basic facility that we have at the genomic and transcriptomic lab. Also, this is a proteomic lab. Okay, so we have some the system for the purification of the enzyme and so on. And then this is the transgenic and tissue culture lab. Okay, so we have the tissue culture lab, the one that I mentioned at the CPB. Okay, and then we have the transgenic house, is just in front of this main building. Okay. And then we have the bioinformatics lab. Okay, So you can see all the computers there. So then you know, okay, this is the bioinformatics lab. Okay, when you come to Imbasi, you see, okay, all these computers, okay, this is the bioinformatics lab. Okay, so even it's very small lab actually, but that lab have done a lot of data analysis. Okay, a lot of data have been analyzed there. Okay. By using the computer, okay, and also there can be remote, yeah. So if you are, if you cannot come to UKM, you cannot come to Imbasu, you still can do remote, okay. By using the bioinformatic, can use our bioinformatic lab by remote, okay. So we also have the greenhouse, okay, the RTPC2, the transgenic house. So if you have any plants that you want to grow, you can grow it here. We are not restricted for the transgenic only. We also open for other type of plant that if the environment or the setting of that facility is suitable for your study, then you can plant your plant here. Okay. So this is our research plot. Okay, so we have the mangosteen plot. Okay, that one has many years there. Okay, so we also have the kesum plot, the polygonal miners, that one I mentioned. Okay, we also have this plot. Okay, we also have other type of plant. Okay, as well. So you can just come and see. Okay, some of the plant is for research. Some of the plant is for the just to maintain the place, okay, to make sure that all the plant must be grow, so we don't waste our land, okay. Okay, so we have the services at Imbasis, okay. Some of the services, you need to pay for the service, okay, especially the one that working on the metabolomic, you need to pay for that service, okay. So, so we have the GCMS, we have the RCMS, okay. And then we have the HPLC, FTIR, and so on. So, okay, some of equipment, we also can use equipment at CREAM, our research management center. Okay. Okay, so this is just the type of service that we have. Okay. So for the GCMS, you can contact Encik Syahmi Afiq. Okay, Mr. Syahmi Afiq. Person in charge, okay. So they have the charges for user and Imbasi user, UKM user, and also non-user, non-UKM user, okay. There are different charges, okay. As a student, you are be under your Imbasi user, okay. So please contact him for details, what type of service that can provided, what type of sample need to be sent, and so on, okay. Same as the LC top, please contact Puan Sara and Puan Rafida for the details. Okay, different charges for different type of users. Okay, for Imbasis also have the charge, very minimum charge for Imbasis student actually. Okay, so HPLC. So this is under Encik Syahmi, Hazim Syahmi. Okay, so there's the one that in charge for the HPLC. Okay, so different charges as well. And then FTRR, okay, Puan Rafida and also Encik Hazim Syahmi, okay. Okay, we also have the omics data analysis. Okay, this is the center, we call it CODA, Center of Data Analysis for Omic Data actually. Okay, then you can do your analysis here under the center with a minimum charges actually, okay. But as a student, you need to analyze yourself. Okay, but you can learn how to do the analysis with them actually, okay. So this is the center, okay. So you can contact Dr. Sarah Hani for details on the center. Okay, what charges, what service that can be provided by us, okay. Okay, so we have the genomic and transcriptomic, okay, metabolomics, proteomics, bioinformatics, okay. So research at Imbasi. So our research focus, as I mentioned previously, we need to address the SDG, okay, goals, okay, and then that's why we have a select, okay, choose the SDG that fit us well, okay. But still, other SDG are welcome as well, okay, as long as this is under the system biology type of study, okay. So we have the omics study, computational system biology, synthetic biology, okay, and in vitro technology, structural body, all these, we go towards the translational research, because nowadays Malaysia plan is to have the translational research, no more fundamental research. But we still need the fundamental for us to understand before we can do the translational research. Okay, that's the spirit actually. Okay, so in BICES, okay, in a glimpse, okay, so we have a study on different phytomiceutical, okay, which is we have all the herbals plant of Malaysia that we are exploring, discovering a new knowledge of this plant. Okay, so for example, when we talk about ketum, people will talk about the opioid receptor, we talk about the morphine-like effect, right? But at Imbisys, we are not doing that. We are not focusing on that. Okay, that's a drug. Okay, we are exploring a new way how ketum can be benefit humans. Okay, so we want to make sure that people will not looking at ketum as a controversy plant, but looking at it as a benefit plant that can have the health benefit to humans. Okay, that's the idea. Okay, so we are looking at the different angle. Okay, so and then so we have the all these frontier study. Okay, most of them published in high impact journals. Okay, frontiers type of journals. Okay, so all the study at Imbisys, I believe, are very impactful. Okay, so you are lucky to register yourself at Imbisys. Okay, so you have a very high publication later on. Okay, so publication also will be rewarded to the students. Okay, I think Dr. Goh will explain about that later. Okay, so the omics guided. Okay, in a phytomedicine, in research for the new genes, protein, metabolites can develop, okay, into the therapies, so maybe into the new drugs. Okay, so that's the idea. Okay, so how we integrate from the system biology to the synthetic biology. Okay, so system biology, as we know, this is very fundamental study. Okay, discovering, exploring different type of omics. Okay, so and then to understand the biological system. Okay, then synthetic biology is towards the translational research. Okay, how the system biology approach can be translated into the synthetic biology approach. Okay, that's the holistic study that Imbisys are focusing on. Okay. Okay, just like to share with you our publication. Okay, until up to now. Okay, 2022. Okay. So for our publication, every year we achieve the targets, the university target. This target is based on the university, yeah, based on the MIRA targets. We achieve the targets every year. But this year we are still pushing to the limits, so we can achieve the target for 2022. Okay. So as for now, we have many paper has been submitted. Okay, hopefully by end of this year, I will see some improvement on the data. Okay, but I'm sure all of us are working very hard to achieve our own personal KPI and also the university KPI and also MIRA KPI. Okay, so all these are integrated. Okay. So our personal KPI and also university KPI. Okay, so your student also, your KPI to graduates. Okay, student, as you know, master student need to have one papers, okay, WAS journals, and PhD need to have two papers, WAS journals. Okay, so you also your KPI, your self KPI to be for you to be graduated. Okay, so we need to work together, okay, to achieve the goals. Okay. So as you can see here, publication on the Q1 and Q2 journals, every year we have a very high numbers of Q1 and Q2 journals. Okay, so all of our journal mostly are journals index. Okay, but some there's a non-index journals. Okay, and then we also have publication in top 10% journals. Okay. So for the grant received, for this year itself, we received about 1.3 million, okay, the amount of grant that we received, yeah, this year only. So this is a lot of money, okay, that need to be spent for us to do research and to help to cater your needs in your research. So we can buy consumable chemical for you to do your research. Okay, just the student, you need to focus on your research. Okay, the one that looking for the money is your advisor, us, the academic staff that looking for the money. The student just need to focus on your own research. Okay, so then we work. Okay, to make sure that we want to make sure that all the research can meet this is another KPI lah, research grant KPI. You need to meet that milestone, and also for the student to meet your own milestone for your master or PhD thesis. Okay. Okay, so this is to show to you the some of our fellow that receive research grants. Okay, so for this year, okay. Okay, so congrats to all our research fellow that were working very hard to work on the research proposal, then they get the grants. Okay, just to highlight a bit on our UKM new narrative on the national aspiration, okay, Universiti Watan kita, okay. So in at UKM, we have the plan strategy, okay. So under the plan strategy, we have now is our plan strategy on based on the TERAS, okay. So T for talent, E for ethics, R for revitalize, A for agile, and S for soul. Okay, so all of the student, you need all of us actually. Okay, the academic staff, the staff, the lab staff, all the staff. Okay, UKM warga, okay, or UKM family. Okay, need to understand this teras. Okay. So all our research are actually covered in all these teras, okay. So we have this, we have the ethic issues, okay. We have the value, the quality, the ecosystem, okay. And how the creativity, the leadership, okay, governance, and so on. It's all is under this teras. I think it's covered everything, okay. So the agenda of UKM, there's only two agenda under this trust. Okay, there's two agenda. This is the graduate employability, okay, and also generation income, okay, the income generation, okay. So this is only two main agenda that all of us need to focus, okay. So as I said to the previous student, even you already graduated, we also need to follow you. We also need to find you. We also need to chase you, because we want to know you got a job or not. Okay, that's our job. Okay, even you already have graduated. Okay, don't lose contact with us. Okay, please keep in touch. Okay, you should be in our loop. Okay, so we know that's our alumni. Is already have a good job, okay. Just because all this is the matter of UKM. We give you the knowledge. Then after that, we want you to use the knowledge in terms of you got a job or you got money, okay. So and that's the ideas, okay. So and also as a university. Research university, we also need other than do research, we also need to generate, okay, income. So that's why we have the services, okay. We charge you some money because we need to generate the money to maintain at least our equipment, to maintain the institute, to maintain our building, because some of it we need to pay by using our own funding, okay. Institute also have our own tabung, okay. There's some money there, okay, to be used to repair the equipments in the lab, to repair the building, and so on. That's why we need to generate income, okay. So okay, live at Imbisis, okay. So we have many talks this year, okay. During the pandemic, we have many webinar, okay. So this year we still have webinar still carry on. Okay, we still have online activities. by the webinars. Okay, we invite the industries, we invite international researchers, okay, and also some of us are also presenting in that webinar. Okay. So we have many more webinar coming. Okay, I think it's less than 8 okay now. Okay. So then some of that workshop that we have, okay. So the workshop is to disseminate the knowledge, okay, to show our expertise, okay, to show people, okay, Invisive have this kind of expertise. Okay, we have expert in this field and so on. Okay, so we want to show off up to the international level, okay, that we in under this one roof we have many experts. Okay, all these experts need to perform a workshop, so to show off, okay, showcase ourselves, okay, show what we have actually, and also to show our facility as well. Okay, so we have the microbial synthetic biology workshop last time in 2020, RNA sequencing data analysis. Okay, and then proteomic workshop in 2021, pathway construction workshop. So this is some of that workshop that we have. Okay, so for 2022, we have many more workshop. Okay, or some of it already done and some are coming soon. Okay, please stay tuned to our information in our social media. You can have the information about the workshop, and the workshop are very useful to you, especially the new student, okay, and maybe for the senior student also useful for you to refresh or also to learn something new techniques, okay, during that workshop that will teach you how to do research on metabolomics, proteomics, and so on. Okay, okay, so we have this proteomics pathway analysis workshop, GCNMS, okay, CRISPR workshop, and also the NPRA registration, pharmaceutical and nutraceutical product last time. Okay, and advanced transcriptomy and NGS workshop. Okay, some of workshop we carry out that workshop physical, okay, some of it online. Okay, so we still have some hybrid as well. Okay, so this is some activity by the Persatuan Siswazah, yeah, the Imbasis Postgraduate Association. Okay, some of the activities conducted this year, so there's many more big event that will be coming soon. Okay, that the president will share with you later. Okay, so this is the activity that we have last year under the under this association. Okay, under the postgraduate symposium. Okay, last year then we will have this also coming. Okay, and then this is some information, then you can go to our just check from our website. Okay, there's a information about Imbisi, the insider, the bulletin. Okay, so all this you can just scan your QR code. Okay, we are not really printing it now because we don't want to waste we don't want to kill the tree. Okay, they want to waste all the papers. Okay, you can just go online. Okay, and then we also have the new society, Malaysian Society of System and Synthetic Biology, My Bios. Okay, so please join us as a member of this society. Okay, so the detail about the society, you can reach out in our website. Okay, so I think that's all from me. Thank you. Okay, if you have any question, if no question, then I can just stop. Okay. I think we have 11 new students, right? I hope all the new students are here today. Maybe you can introduce yourself, please. The new student, can you introduce yourself?
Maybe we can start with PhD student.
Yeah.
We have Kasum. Kasum is here, is it?
Yes, I am here.
Can you open your camera so we can see your face?
Is it okay?
Yeah, we can see you clearly. Okay. Okay, can you please introduce yourself?
Hello everyone, Assalamualaikum. My name is Umi Falsumendi Azlan. I am a PhD student, registered, supervised under Dr. Hamiza. So previously I did my master at UM. Now I'm currently doing project on Moringa to test the Moringa effect on neuro disease.
Okay. Okay, thank you, Umi. Kasum. Yeah.
Thank you.
Welcome to Invices. Okay, next.
Yes, thank you.
Next, maybe Taha. Taha is here.
Yes, I'm here.
All right.
Okay, hello. Taha.
Yes, can you hear me?
Cannot see you. Can hear you, but cannot see you.
Sorry?
Cannot see your face. Can you switch on your camera, please?
Is it good now?
No, I cannot see it.
Now?
Okay,
this is Taha Sindhi. I am a PhD student under supervision of Dr. Ahmed Mediani, and my project will be around about anti-diabetic effect of a plant extraction.
Okay. Where are you from, Taha?
I'm from Pakistan.
Pakistan. Which part of Pakistan?
Sindh, the south part.
South part. Okay.
Yes.
No, on the Kashmir part. Okay. So, okay. Thank you, Taha.
Thank you.
All right. So, we have another international student. Can I ask Kalipu Sri Raja Rajeshwari Devi to introduce himself?
Please, ma'am. Can you see me?
Yes.
Yeah. Good morning, everyone. I'm Rajeshwari Kalepu. I'm from India. I have completed my master's in bioinformatics and I have joined PhD student under North Ajlan, sir. My research is on a red palm weevil to control the pest control.
Okay. So you are in Malaysia or still in India?
India, ma'am.
Okay. So please come next semester, okay?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
All right. So can I call another student, Zhang Meng Zhao from China? Are you here?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes.
So my camera may be wrong. I open the camera but I can't see myself.
Okay, it's okay. Okay, Zhang.
Okay. My name is Zhang Mengjie. I'm from Inner Mongolia of China. I'm a PhD because I'm not discussed with my teacher, so I don't know my project is now.
You discuss with me later, okay?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Thank so you. Another. Okay. Thank you. So we have another PhD student. But I'm not sure if he is here or not because he just registered yesterday. Mengfei, is Mengfei here?
Okay.
All right. Yeah, he is here. Yeah.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Mengfei. I come from China.
Which part of China?
Yeah.
Which part of China?
I come from China.
Yeah. Which part? Are you from Mongolia, Beijing?
Shandong.
South. Okay. Okay. Please introduce yourself, Mengfei.
Thank you.
Your supervisor? Who is your supervisor? Is it Dr. Go or Dr. Hamidun?
I'm also not sure.
Sorry, I don't know.
Okay, later you check who is your supervisor, okay?
Okay.
He's my student, and then want to talk to me. Oh,
all right.
You have to contact me to discuss, yeah?
Okay. Okay. Dr. Go is your supervisor, okay? Okay, nice to meet you.
Nice
so
to meet you.
You are still in China, right?
Hey, thank you.
Okay. Okay. Okay, who else? So we have 5 PhD students now. Who else?
Yeah, now because we only have 5 PhD students. Okay. So now is the master students. We have 8 master students. Can we start with Muhammad Razin?
Razin, is it?
Yep, Razin.
Cannot hear.
The connection is breaking, I think.
Where are you? Are you in Malaysia or where?
He's in biases.
Okay. cannot hear you, Razin.
All right, we continue later with Razin. Okay. So let me call Nurul Shahidah.
Okay.
Hi. Can you hear me?
Yes.
I am Nurul Shahidah binti Mio Asmi. Before this, I did my degree in science biology in University of Malaysia Terengganu. But I'm currently doing my master's in biosis under my supervisor, Dr. Nurhalida Kamal, with the project of targeted metabolomics of isoflavones in tempeh.
Okay. So you are at your house, right?
Yes.
okay. Where are you now?
In Bangi.
Oh, Bangi. Okay.
My house is near GMI.
Oh, okay. Okay. So welcome to Imbasis, Nurul Shahida.
Thank you.
Okay, next.
Next, let me call Nur Aisha.
Hi, can you see me?
Yes.
Okay.
Hello, my name is Nur Aisha. I am a master student under the supervision of Dr. Hamizah. My project is about the effect of mitragynine supplementation on neuroinflamed rats.
Okay. So Aisha, you are where are you now?
Oh, at my home.
Oh, no, you're not in USM yet.
Oh, not yet. Waiting for USM reply right now.
Okay. Okay, welcome to Imbiasis.
Okay. All right, so the next one, let's welcome Tay Jiarong.
Hi everyone. My name is Tay Jiarong. So I just joined Imbiasis. My project is about plant-based coactive lipase. And this about mainly focus on structural and functional study. And this project is under supervision of Dr. Ng Cheng Leong.
Okay. You are in Imbiasis, right?
Yeah, I'm in the Imbiasis.
Okay, okay. Okay, welcome. Okay, next.
Next, let me welcome Ivana. Ivana Nur Alisha.
Hi, Assalamualaikum. Good morning. Can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
Okay, my name is Ivana Nur Alisha binti Roslan.
Kena adjust sikit kamera kot. Tak nampak, half je. Okay.
My name is Ivana Nur Alisha binti Roslan. Currently, I am under the supervision Dr. Nur Khalida studying on metabolomics, a study of modified TMP.
Okay. So where are you now?
I am in Terengganu, Besut Terengganu.
Oh, okay. Okay, where you come? You will plan to come to Imbiasis?
Early November, insyaAllah.
Oh, okay. Okay, see you next week.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Okay, next.
All right, so now the next one, the next student is Siti Norliana.
Okay.
Jana, we cannot hear you.
Unmute, please. Okay.
My name is Siti Nuliana binti Cik Mat Zubaidi. I'm under supervision Dr. Ahmad Madiani. My research is about Andunan Muricata, focusing on its anti-diabetic effect through metabolomic study.
Okay. Right. Where are you now?
At home.
At home where?
At Bangi.
Near Bangi, to okay. Okay. I thought you dekat library.
No.
Okay. Okay, welcome, Nuliana.
Thank you.
Okay. So.
All right. So now let's welcome Nor Shakila.
Hi, Assalamualaikum.
Salam.
Hi, good morning, everyone. My name is Nor Shakila. I'm a master student under supervision of Associate Prof. Dr. Radha Uthman. My project is about metabolic engineering for microbial production of agave biofragrance. So it's very nice to meet you all and thank you.
Hey, welcome, Shakila.
Thank you.
Okay, next.
All right, and the last student, Nurul Amalia. Nurul Amalia? Amalia, we cannot hear you and we cannot see you.
Well, we move on to the next one first, Muhammad Razin.
Okay, Muhammad Razin, yeah. Still have technical issue with Razin, I think.
Razin? Razin? Okay tak? Jom.
Hello.
Ah, okay.
Hello.
Okay, 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 okay. Okay, now we can hear you. Okay. Okay. You,
Hello, can anyone hear me?
Yeah, yeah. Please continue, please.
Oh, okay. I'm not sure why my camera is not working right now. Can I just introduce myself?
Yeah, please, please.
Okay. Hello, and assalamualaikum and greeting to everyone. My name is Muhammad Razin Sofi. I'm currently doing my master's in the topic of how fanazine and encapsulated fanazine in nanosilica particles effects have an antibiotic effects against Geoderma bionensis in oil palm.
Your supervisor?
And my supervisor is, I'm under the supervision of Dr. Nisha. And that's it.
Okay. Razin, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Razin.
You're welcome.
Now let's go back again to Nurul Amalia. Nur Amalia, still having same problem, is it?
Hi.
Okay. We can hear you.
I can start the video.
Tak apa. It's okay.
Tak apa. It's okay.
Okay. Hi, everyone. My name is Nur Amalia binti Zahari. I'm currently doing master under Dr. Nur Khalida. With project that study dynamic metabolite changes during tempeh fermentation.
Okay. Thank you.
All right, that time that's all the PhD students and master students, new students that registered for this semester.
So we have 13, right?
Yes, we have 8 for masters and 5 for PhD. So 13, yes.
Okay. Okay, thank you so much, everyone. So hope to see Amalia and Razin face later. Okay. Okay. So thank you. I think if there is not any question, any question from the students? So if no question, then I stop. Okay, my session. Okay, thank you so much. Okay, see you around. Okay, bye.
Thank you very much, Dr. Sharul Natakain, our director.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Biases. Not yet. Goodbye. So now we move on to the next session, which is the introduction of In Biases Postgraduate Society by the president of Postgraduate Society of In Biases. Please welcome Mr. Akil.
Hello. Hello. Can you hear me?
Yes.
All right.
I can hear you.
All right.
Yes, yes.
All right. Let me share my slide. I think first of all, I think I will share a video on welcoming the new student. Can you see the video? Sorry.
Yes.
Okay. So I will play.
Very nice video.
All right. Okay. Sorry. So I will proceed with my slide. Everyone can see my slide?
Yes, Akil, you can see your slide.
Okay, yes, I'll continue. Yes. All right, thank you. Okay, I will introduce you on the In Biases Postgraduate Society. So the first thing first is the why we have this society. Actually, this is according to the constitution of our society, which is society act as an intermediate between student and administration, and then we act as a platform for student engagement for sharing our research outcome, and then we channel for effective scientific understanding between the institute and the community. Okay, so currently actually every student in IBC should be registered as SAI members. Currently, suppose we have 51 postgraduate students, and 56% of it is from the PhD student. However, another 44% is from the master's student. But actually, the active student around 30 something, and then everyone should actually pay the registration fee, which is around 10 ringgit. But however, currently only like 22% that paid the registration fee. So the rest might be, you can meet Amni, our vice Timbalan Bendahari, to pay this registration fee. Later, I will introduce Amni to you. Okay, as for the new student, you need to pay RM10, yeah, for registering this this society. Okay, this is our advisors. First is our director of Imbiasis, which is Prof. Madia, Associate Professor Dr. Sharun Atakai Baharum. And then hello.
Yes, okay, we can hear you, but we lost your
my video, right? Yeah. Yes. Okay, I just continue, can I?
All right, yes.
Okay. Can. All right. We also have our chair of Jawatan Kuasa Siswaza, Associate Professor Dr. Goh Hohan, and also our advisor, Dr. Nohalida Kamal. And then let me introduce the Jawatan Kuasa. First, me as the president. You can find me at Metabolomics Lab. I'm a PhD student. And then proceed with my deputy or the vice president, Ahmad Faris Kamaruzaman. You can find him at Proteomics Lab. As for our secretary, Nur Afika, you can find her at Metabolomics Lab also. She is a PhD student. Yashir is our vice secretary in Metabolomics Lab or Genomics Lab. And then Praveen, you could find him in Proteomics Lab. The one that will collect your registration fee is Nur Amni, our vice bendahari. You can find her at Genomics Lab. Okay, this is our ahli jawatan kuasa for the academic bureau, which is Anis Nadira Zifridin. As Bureau Sukan Sports and Recreation, we have Nurhani Nicheela. And for the media and publicity, and the one who edit the video, the TikTok video, that one is Nur Fikri Omar, our handsome guy here. And then this is our Ketua Makmal. If there anything happen in your lab, Ketua Makmal is the one that responsible in your lab. If in bioinformatic lab, we have Vino. As for genomic, we have Matt. For metabolomics lab, we have Nur Azli Gadin. And for proteomic, we have this handsome guy, Zanul Azri. So if there's any problem in your lab, you can meet this four person or your PIC, which will later be introduced by Dr. Goh. So usually this is the not annual, but I think every semester we will face this activity. This is compulsory for the active student. This is our research progress seminar. This is the photo from our latest seminar. You can see our director here. Okay. And then we also have an outreach program, which is known as iBatch. We target the school students, secondary school students, and then we try to engage what our research, what our business to them. And then we try to create their interest on biotechnology. Okay, and then we also have International Postgraduate Symposium in Biology, Biotechnology, and Bioengineering, also known as AIDS Bio3. It first been in 2021, if I'm not mistaken. Using online platform. So this is a success activity, and hopefully we could do this later, inshallah. And another activities that usually we do is career talk. We also have an academic visit. Sometimes we also have a recreation activity, such as BBQ and potluck. We love to eat. And then as we eat, we burn our calories. Of course, we have our sports, ping pong, badminton. We also play bowling, tennis, basketballs, and you name it. Okay, so for the upcoming events, we will try to conduct INOW, which is Imbiasis Outreach Week. which consists of IBEX, Ismaritri and IREX. So hopefully the new student could participate also. That's all from me, thank you. And then please follow our social media in Facebook, Twitter, Instagram and TikTok. I think that's all from me. Thank you.
Thank you, Akhil. But I have one question, Akhil. If the new student would like to enroll as a member of PSI, how they will could contact Amni? Will Amni share the Google form for the membership application or how?
I think later I will ask the maybe the secretary and the vice secretary to create a Google form, and then from data is better to us for having the list.
Okay, thank you very much to Akhil. Very nice video, very lively the society. So I would like to invite all students, new to student, to register to this society so that you can have a good connection with your seniors and your peers, so that you will enjoy your life while you studying in BIOSIS. So again, thank you very much to Akhil.
All right.
So without further ado,
Dr. Noharita, I would like to invite all the PSAI ESCO member to turn on their webcam. Say hi to everyone. To acknowledge their contribution for the PSAI, for all the hard work. So Akhil, you would like to invite your vice president. Is he around?
I don't think.
Are they all around? They are supposed to join the briefing.
My vice president is just have a newborn yesterday. So I don't think that he's available right now.
Okay, so for others, please turn on your camera.
I will introduce my secretary, Afika Yusof. Afika, can you introduce yourself?
Hi. So I'm Afika. If you guys want to ask something, maybe you can just see me or other people inside. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. Just everyone just turn on their camera. No need one by one. All the PSAI ESCO member, please turn on your camera and show yourself. So Amni.
Can I show myself?
Yes. Sure. Who else?
Yash, Praveen.
Praveen.
Well, everyone can just turn on their camera and take a group photo for now.
Can also.
Well, everyone's here, just might as well turn on a camera and take a photo now. Later. So, Zhang Mengjiao, I think we still cannot see you. It's still a black screen.
Sorry, yes, I have opened my camera, but I don't see myself. Maybe it's wrong. I will.
Yeah, you have to fix that issue for the lecture in the future, yeah? The others, please.
Please turn on your camera and prepare to smile.
Who is going to take the photo? Intan.
Please, Intan.
Okay, our Pengarah.
Pengarah is here.
Yeah.
Hey, everyone.
I don't think we can see Ting. Okay, Dr. Ng. Dr. Basley, Dr. Ahmed. All fellows also can turn on your camera. Dr. Kamurazlan. Lalita, Matresa, Maya, else. We still cannot see Razin. Shakila, Rupa, Shahira, Shasha, Taha, Yash, Omi, Faiz, Ravin, Chupa, Aslina. We have many, many, we have around 60, I think. There are some redundant. So we share more, but it's okay. So, yes.
Can we take photo now?
Ching Ching. Maya is very dark. You have to turn, close the curtain behind you. Amy, Rihanna. Okay. Moss, Ivana. Yeah, okay. Okay, Intan?
Okay. I think we have three pages here. Okay, the first one. 1, 2, 3, smile.
With baby, Dr. Basley.
Okay, second page. 1, 2, 3, smile. Okay. Okay, one more. 1, 2, 3. Smile. Okay. Last one. Okay. Freestyle. 1, 2, 3, smile. Okay. Okay, done.
Thank okay, you. Thank you everyone. Thank you, PSAI. I'll introduce some more of you in a while. So we continue with the briefing for today. Okay, so I'll share my screen. Okay, everyone can see my screen, right?
Yes, Dr.
Okay, so I'll start with the briefing. So everyone already got the file. If not, then you can download the briefing from the website of Inbiosis under students, the guidelines. Later, I'll show you. So basically, today, we're going to cover some of the important regulations when you start at Inbiosis as a new student. So I'll go through some of the important rules and regulations that you have to follow as a postgraduate student. But before that, we want to get to know more of you as an audience. So let's have an ice-breaking session so everyone can get interactive. So you can go to this link, URL, I think everyone can access. Sorry. Let me activate. Okay, so can everyone access the URL? Okay. So everyone can see the screen. Yeah, just to know whereabout are you at the moment. So around like 1/4 of you are physically at embassy and most of you are from online at home. Physically, meaning you can online at embassies, but physically present at embassies at the moment. Okay, so around 30% at embassies. All right, so everyone's answered, right? So the next one, just to know the gender. So this include the fellows, not just the student. Everyone please answer and join this. So everyone that's present here, please join the poll EV to answer, including the RA, the intern, everyone that's present at WebEx, please answer the poll. Okay, so we have also 24% they are male, mostly are females in the audience. Next. So now it's about where are you from? Physically now, physically. If you are abroad, then you write non-Malaysian. So if you are in Malaysia, say Malaysia. Even though you might be from abroad, but now you're currently in Malaysia, so you can say yeah, Malaysia. So very few are out of Malaysia. So this year is very special. Previous year we have only one every semester, but this year we have more than one, there's like 3 and 4 international students. So this is the first year ever that we have so many international students. So around 4% are non-Malaysia. So if you are Malaysian, this is not present in Malaysia, but just Malaysian. Where is your hometown? You can click, this is hometown, not like where are you now? Your hometown in Malaysia. Okay, we can see a lot of Selangor, yes, Perak, Terengganu. So for those from outside of Malaysia, this is the map of Malaysia. We have like 13 states and one federal territory with consisting Putrajaya, Kuala Lumpur, and also Labuan. Okay, so we have from East Malaysia, some East Malaysian. Okay. There's none from Malacca on the Great Sembilan. Penang, there's also no one. Okay. All right. So for those that are not from Malaysia, can you write where are you from? Hometown, like your origin from. So India. Only India, the others. By the way, can China access pollev.com?
Yes, we can.
Can you? Meng Jiao?
Yes, we can.
So can you type?
Oh, okay.
And Taha, you're from Pakistan, right? I expect at least like 2 or 3 countries in the answer. Okay, thank you, Taha. Meng Fei and Meng Jiao.
Meng Jiao, type in the chat, Dr. Go.
Oh, no, you shouldn't type in the chat. You have to go to this website. Please follow the instruction. Go to pollev.com/GHH725 on your browser to answer the poll. Same for Meng Fei, from Algeria. Meng Fei as well, please get involved. We are waiting. Faster, then we can end the session earlier. Please, please participate. Meng Fei and Meng Zhao, please join the pollev.com.
Hello, Professor. Can you write the website?
You can just type. This is the website. See on top.
Okay.
OEV.com. Can someone type in the chat for them? Mine's a bit yet. Ah, it's already in the chat.
Yeah, Taha and yeah, we type it.
Okay, so for the new student, you have better get familiar with such tools, because when we are doing online lecture, you are not passive listener only. You have to get involved. Nowadays, it's all interactive teaching, so you have to be involved. You are not just passive listener. You have to contribute with others. Okay, so just bear that in mind. Same for these sessions. So next questions. So there are many, many categories here. Choose the one applicable to you. Okay, we don't have research assistant today, and intern also don't have. If they are new students, they must join the afternoon session. That's compulsory, definitely, for the lab briefing. So it's okay if they don't join for the new student or embassies meeting. We don't have any staff also this morning. Okay, so we're almost half master and PhD student that join us today. But this year, we have a lot of new master students compared to the PhD students. Okay, thank you. So we have the fellow joining also. It's important. Oh, okay, we have the staff also. All right. So for those that are working on research, you can choose which organism they are mainly working on. If you don't know, you just type, you just choose the others or unsure for new students. And for the staff, researcher, fellow, you can also choose. So there's no human, mostly are plants. And that's basically the main focus of imbiosis, plant omics. Okay, so we can see like the second most is animals and then microbes, then others. For those that don't know yet, please consult your supervisor as soon as possible to discuss on your project. Okay, which lab are you mainly based at? For those that don't know, just choose unsure. So we have a lot of metabolomics. Okay. Yes, dominating metabolomics member. Some are unsure, especially the new students that are still not yet in biosys. So you're working from home. So unsure are WFH, working from home. Okay, so we have the least genomics. All right, let me see. Which semester are you now? For the new student, you can choose semester one. For those that are returning student, can choose whichever semester applicable to you. So we have a lot of seniors. Okay, so the seniors should take care of the juniors, hopefully, and there's a succession in the future. So for those in the second, fourth semester, and the fifth, seventh semester, hopefully you can graduate soon. Okay, those that semester eight, work harder and try to complete as soon as possible, yeah? Don't give up. It's a long journey, Okay, so for this briefing, what you expect? I already sent out the slide. I'm not sure whether some of you have gone through the slide, but actually, what do you want to learn from the briefing? I don't want to just read through the slide because the slide already provided to you, but what you actually want to learn that I want to focus on. So can you type in there, especially for the new student, or probably you are not sure what should be in the briefing. Today's actually there are three parts of the briefing. First is all about imbalances. What imbalances is all about by the director. Then what's the society of the student society about? Then in the afternoon, we have Dr. An Chan Leong on the lab, which is very important for those doing lab work in the lab. You need to know the rules also. But me as the chairperson of the postgraduate committee to make sure that you understand that when you enroll in the program, what is expected of you? What rules applicable to you? How many semester you are allowed to study? And at what semester you have to submit certain form for deferment or for extension? For now, you might not know that you need that yet, but in the future, nearer to the date, you can refer to that I have already told you, and you will be reminded every semester because you have to come back to this briefing again every semester. However, please bear that in mind that you have to understand all these rules as a student at UKM. Okay, so some of you want to know the current update about the thesis notice, about the criteria of conversion from master to PhD. GOT is graduate on time. For those that don't know, graduate on time, I'm going to describe about that also later. And awards, yes, some like to know about the award. The award for the previous semester progress seminar will be announced also in my talk. So looking forward to that for those that work hard for your progress. Latest terms and rules, okay. Opportunity to do research attachment. This one you have to work hard for it, and your supervisor will help you to look for the opportunity, but you yourself have to look out for the opportunity. Academic tentative and requirement, this one will be covered. Okay, condition to grad, yes. Graduate support system, yes, we have support system. We're going to inform that. Criteria for graduating, are there any changes to the latest criteria? There is no changes yet. The number of population is still 2 for PhD and 1 for master, luckily. Okay. Deduction of 2 semester due to this one already informed previously that you have to apply for it and it's not automatic. You have to submit the form and you might be possibly need to pay back your studentship if you receive GRA for that semester. I'm not sure, so I'm not guaranteed. So career opportunity, but probably a bit too soon for a student briefing. Okay, but as a GRA, probably yes, for those intern and RA. Fast track PhD, if you are asking this already too late, already enrolled, probably for the intern, you can know about this. And I'll explain later why it's better to go through conversion than fast track PhD. And yeah, the criteria also I'm going to brief about. Anymore? Pattern as part of publication, is it applicable to thesis by compilation too? This one is not stated in the thesis by compilation because thesis compilation only applicable for publication, not pattern. Okay, so that's probably not, but it can be counted as a criteria for graduate. Okay, anything else? Alumni career records. I don't have that data, but it's an interesting request that our Penyara Siswaza can probably look into. And we have the alumni, so probably can get their feedback on their current job. Okay, feedback from alumni. Feedback from alumni. This one probably will have alumni sessions in the future, but not today. Anything else? I think that's all. Most of it will be covered. So we'll move on to our briefing today. So let's skip this. Okay, thank you everyone for participating in the poll EV. Okay, so just continue our briefing today. Just now I skipped a slide in the front. Usually usually we have at the university level, there's a briefing for all the postgraduate as well. But this year, delay. There will be one, but in a few weeks' time. Yesterday, I talked to the new Timbalam, deputy director of the postgraduate center. Currently, it's under Academic UKM. So it's already changed the management, so it's slightly delayed probably. There will be briefing for postgraduate later on, okay? So especially on the library side. So the new student need to know how to access the library, how to access the database, how to get the literature, download all those things, right? Returning student already know, but the new student probably still unsure how you access the library resources, how to access some ebook from the library. All those should be covered in the postgraduate briefing from the library in the a few weeks' time. So also you will learn about it from the RBRB 6014 or 8014 for the PhD, depending what courses you're taking, what other things they need to know. Okay, so the other administrative part at the UNC level will be covered also. And for the international student, they will be mentioning about the requirement for studying Malay language. So you do sit for some courses on the Malay language that is not provided at Embassies, but at the UNC level that you have to take. Another thing about writing thesis in English for the non-Malaysian or the international student, I will be covering also, that you have to apply regardless of whether you are international or local student with justification. If you are international student, it's definitely you will be approved to write thesis in English, but you have to still submit the application form, okay? So this one already covered by director just now. We have two programs, the PhD and the Master of Science in System Biology. Previously, we have Master in System Biology with different subtopic, but from last year or the year before onwards, we already consolidate into one as a Master of Science in System Biology. Okay, this is a statistic as of semester, the previous semester. We have 30 PhD students and 21 master students that's active. Whereas alumni, we have 36 master alumni and PhD graduate 19. So we have 19 doctorate from Embassies. And this is the one that I just updated just now with the blue font. So we can see that we have added 4 PhD and 8 master. In total, we have now 29 master and 34. Just now, Taha actually registered previous semester. He's currently second semester compared to you all new student are semester one. That's why he's not in the plus one. Okay, so so far this year, we have Dr. Noor Halida with the most new student. Well done and good luck. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, so this all covered by director just now. Please have a look on what actually Embassy is about because it's related to the program that we offer. And this is also covered by director just now on the different focus area in general. And this is in Malay language, sorry about that for the international student, but because the narrative is in English, I don't have the in Malay language, I don't have the English version. You can Google translate in later. Okay, so for the educational goal, also just now briefly gone through. In general, at the UKM level, we want to produce graduates who appreciate the national aspiration. If it's a national university, that's what UKM stands for. And you need to be competent, competitive, innovative. So we have to make sure that you are not just competing among yourself at Embassies, but competing with the world. You want to be world-class. We want to produce world-class graduates. And remember the initial intention why you joined Embassies for a postgraduate study in the first place. And by the way, for all the new postgraduate and the existing postgraduate, congratulations for making it so far. Not everyone can go to postgraduate level. So to make it at this stage, or for those that's until 8 semester, well done and a good effort to maintain your postgraduate journey with us. Okay. So we also have the educational program objective that form the foundation of our program. There are 4, we call them OPP. So all this I'm not going to reiterate, but basically we are focusing on complex biological questions. We are tackling complex biology in the system biology, and also nowadays we add in the synthetic biology elements. So we want you to be learning the latest technology. This is for the master, 8 HPP. This is progress learning outcome, and in Malay is Hasil Pendidikan program. That's a HPP, or English is PLO. So you can read through this. I'm not going through it, but there's a difference between the master and PhD level, and this will be covered in the workshop next week also about what's distinguished between master and PhD level. And this, the supervisor should appreciate this. You cannot force a master student to the level of PhD. You have to judge the level of your student level. So don't expect too much independence at the master level compared to the PhD level. Whereas the PhD level, you have to give them more independence and sharpen their skill as an independent researcher. So there's a two different level to balance for the students at different levels. And you can see this at the end of your viva as well. The examiner and your supervisor have to fill in this form. So this is at the end of the journey. Before you embark the start of the semester for the new student, you need to know what's the end of the journey for you. This is the end, almost the end. You yet to submit your hard copy viva. This is after the viva, your examiner going to fill in this to evaluate whether you have achieved the learning outcome from the program. Okay, so you need to know this, whether you already have the skill for this. And this is for the PhD. It's color-coded, red for PhD and blue, cyan for the master. So all this, I have underlined the difference between the master and PhD level. So as a PhD, you have this originality and you synthesize knowledge compared to master, less so. And you have to be skilled in many things compared to master, you're still learning. Okay, so the beginning is all about registration. So you can get this kind of calendar on our website, also from the Postgraduate Center website. You just Google for academic calendar UKM, then you get this. Then you know when the semester for you to register for a new student and also for the returning student. For the returning student, there are many of you, I'm not sure why the reason, you don't register early and you have to pay the penalty. Don't expect scholarship or Zamala. Just register when it is open. You get refunded if you get the Zamala. So just save up your money for the next semester. Don't think that the last minute only the money will come. So you have to save up for the rainy day. When you receive stipend for those that are lucky to get GRA, please save up. Just in case the grant run out of the money. So you have to save up throughout your study to pay for the tuition fee. And most of the graduate research assistant, most of the student at Embassies are actually funded by research grant, and they get stipend. We call them as graduate research assistant GRA. And there's a monthly stipend around like 1,006 to 2,004, depend on the type of grant and the supervisor, and also your level, whether master or PhD. So don't compare yourself with each other. Different people are under different grant and different supervisor. So it's all a bonus. By default, there is actually no fund, no money to sub. Like the UKM SHAPE student, actually, they are self-funded. They are not getting paid, and they have to pay for the more expensive tuition fee and also, But the consumable for doing research should be covered by the research grant itself. But sometimes research grant run out. In other university, other places, actually, even the student had to cover the consumable. So consider yourself lucky that in Embassies, all the fellow mostly have research grant to pay for the research. But not every place like that. Some, the student tend to pay the reagent themselves, pay for the services themselves. But at Embassies, we are lucky to have all the research grant to cover, and we have a central consumable funding system that all the supervisor contribute from their research grant to pay for the consumables. However, the specialized reagent chemicals are covered by the grant from the supervisor themselves. So this is specialized, and you have to discuss with your supervisor. So at the university or at the institute level, we have centralized kind of pot of funds. fund to cover the general consumable like pipette tips, the glove, etc. So, but for the specialized chemical, usually we encourage sharing. So to avoid wasteful reagent like urea, for example, a lot of students using the same. If it can be shared or near the expiry date, can just give it to other students to use so that to avoid waste or expiry date. So actually there are a lot of chemicals that are overlapping between the students' project. So we encourage students to communicate with each other and share the chemical and use. And then this also involves communication between the fellow on the research project so that to avoid waste in the chemical or consumables. Okay, but just this slide to remind, in the future for those that's registering for the coming semester, you have to complete the evaluation of all the courses that you take, especially for the second semester registration. You have to complete the evaluation of the course RBRB 6012 and 6014 for the master, and for the PhD is 8014. And the SEM 3 is like you have to, for the PhD, you have to take another RBRB 8022. You have to evaluate the course before you can register. And please register early and register the course also as soon as it's open. Juan or Susanna are going to inform everyone about this. And she has sent out reminder, but yet still students don't register. So please, in the next semester, everyone please register when it's required to register. So the others, this kind of payment, you have to deal with the treasurer of UCAM, Bernardi UCAM. So we're not going to deal with it. So you have to deal with it yourself at the UCAM level. Okay, my job today is just briefly cover the essential part of the regulation, but the guideline itself, the PDF, going to be shared. It's on the website, on the Graduate Center website, and the link is in the slide here. And you can access this in the Malay version, also English version. I'm presenting the bilingual so that the international student can understand. So these are the elements covered by the regulation, from all the way admission requirement all the way to appeal when you're dissatisfied with the Viva exam result. So we are going through this part by part. But apart from this regulation, this is the others. So there are also guidelines. So just now there's regulation, we have also guidelines. And there's a compilation of guidelines also from the website. But however, these guidelines are in Malay language only. So it covers the supervision of the postgraduate. It covers the Viva examination procedure. It covers the compilation thesis. It covers the fast track PhD requirement. Like someone asked, right? You can find out about this. And you can also find out the guideline on the PhD industry from this. And this is compiling all these guidelines already. So there are other things, and all is under the Garis Panduan Pusat Siswaza UCAM. So the link I already given to you. You can use Google Translate for the non-Malay language speaker. So unfortunately, there is no English version for some of them. Okay, I try to find what I cannot find. But for new student, I think by now, the first step is, I think you already filled this letter or undertaking. When you first join UCAM, you have to sign this four form: letter undertaking, non-disclosure undertaking, academic work undertaking, student deed of assignment. All these form the first agreement with the UCAM when you become a student at Embassies or at UCAM. So you have to understand there's all the intellectual property belong to UCAM. All the thesis written publication are all property of UCAM, even though your name. So that is also as written. And you have to keep your project secret. You cannot review what you have done in a way, but not in the present, in terms of like, if it is a secret, but if it's not, you can actually academic presentation at conference, that doesn't count. So, but you have signed all these things about the project. Some project need to be secret, especially with the industry. So you have to bear in mind about this intellectual property and non-disclosure thing from the course you are going to take about intellectual property later. So I'm not going in detail about this, but to bear in mind that you have signed this, and the work that you have done, all the project belong to your supervisor and the university. Okay, the very important things that everyone need to know about the program is about deferment and also extension. Not all will be graduate on time. I understand that because of the personal issues or because of the project itself, that doesn't work. So that's why UKM allowed some flexibility in terms of extension and deferment. At the institute level, in biosys level, we can allow maximum of 3 semester extension and 4 semester of deferment. Deferment usually is due to like financial issue, personal health issue. Like you cannot pay for a semester, you can defer. But this is you have to discuss your supervisor, because most of you will be covered under research grant, and research grant has their own KPI. KPI is like the output you need to promise, like publication or IP. If you defer, then the grant will end. You cannot defer the research grant. Research grant will just keep going, but you can defer your semester. There is such strategy. I'm not sure in the future will change or not. Those that defer might not count as GOT under MIRA, if I'm not mistaken. Am I right? Dr. Ai, for those that defer, currently under UKM, it's still counted because they count the GOT based on the number of registered semester. However, in some university, the deferred semester also counted for the GOT. Am I right, Dr. Ai or Dr. Isaac from CRIM can clarify? I'm not sure, but ideally, you just graduate on time consecutively the semester. But at UKM, if you within seven registered semester, you can complete until you get a standard letter of graduation, you still consider as graduate on time. Yeah, that's at the rule so far. But we try to discourage going through extension or deferment. Okay, if you already extension, that means you won't be GOT. If you defer, try to get to the GOT. That one is a gray area. Okay, so what I mean by that is like you are at your sixth semester, for example, but you want to GOT, so you defer your seventh semester. So, but yet still, as you defer, you are not a student anymore. Strictly speaking, you are not allowed to use a facility at Imbalsis. But if you are at the writing stage, like for example, you yet to publish, so you need more time to publish your manuscript or submit your manuscript, because you have to submit your manuscript to submit the notice of thesis. So you have the evidence of you have completed the manuscript submission to submit your thesis. So if you need this extra time, you might want to defer that semester so that you can register, because you need that time for the writing. You are not doing lab work, or some might do some little lab work. So this allowed them to become like register seventh semester. When you register, then you can submit thesis. You can already and you will have only 7 registered semester, but in actual fact, you already spend like 8 semester in your study, for example. So this is kind of like what I mean by the deferment. But extension, if you have to go through extension, that means you already gone beyond the GOT. Okay, so this is the period for the GOT. GOT is like, even though it's not counted under Malaysian Research Assessment, but strictly speaking, it's 5 semester. Within 5 semester, getting the standard letter, you are considered GOT for master, and 7 semester for PhD, that means 3.5 years. 1 semester is around 6 months. So if you are a full-time master, you have until the 6th semester, that means 3 years, before you need to apply for extension. So meaning to say, if you are at your 6th semester, you have to apply for extension ready to Imbalsis on your 6th semester, 1 month before the end of the 6th semester. So for those in the 6th semester of master, please bear that in mind. You have to, if this semester is your sixth semester, you have to complete your thesis submission. Otherwise, you have to register for another semester. And you have to register, you have to apply for the extension. And it should be approved by Jatan Kuasa Siswaza or the postgraduate committee within this semester. Okay? And if you are part-time, then you have until the eighth semester. Whereas for the PhD, you no need to apply for extension until the 12th semester. So this is a long period. That means 6 years you have before you need to apply for extension. And you can apply up to 3 times extension before the last final time is through the Jatan Kuasa Senate, so at the university level, that they have to approve for your extension. And there's only one. So maximum you can extend is only 4 semesters in total. That means for master, you can only study 5 years maximum. It's 10 semester. Okay, for a PhD, will be up to 16 semester. That will be 8 years. That will be too long already. So you don't want that. Please complete as soon as possible for all your research work. And this is another thing, for change your program, if you feel that imbalance is not suitable for you, you want to convert to program at FSD, it's still doable within 4 weeks. So within this month, you can apply at to director and in writing. And then within 2 semesters of registration is still allowed, but is usually within the 4 weeks from the start of semester, to allow you to change the mode. And usually this is more applicable for the faculty that have like many mode of study, because they have a coursework master. We only have research. So there's no such option within institute to change from coursework to master by research or the other way around. But there's cases that students change from one institute to the other institute. And that is possible, but it has to go through the Senate level at the university level also. So I have to bring this to the university level. It's not determined at the institute level. Another one is a conversion. I think this is applicable a lot for those that in your third semester now. I think I got one inquiry already. In order for you to convert from master to PhD, you have to do it within the third semester. And we already set a rules at Imbalsis. You have to submit application before the 7th week. So in this semester, the deadline will be the 2nd December, 12 p.m. There's a lot of 2 there. We won't forget. 2/12/2022. If you cannot submit your application within that, then you cannot convert to PhD. Then you have to complete your master before you can register for PhD. So for those that are interested to convert to PhD, from master, you have to submit your application by 2nd December. And the criteria is, you should have already achieved most of your master objective. So based on your master proposal, this research objective, you have already achieved most of it, and you already have some publication or manuscript proof that you achieved all those objectives, and you can move on to a PhD level with another additional research objective to go more in depth. And you have to submit your thesis, your mini thesis or the master. That means you already written the master thesis in a way that to prove that you already done the work. If almost done the whole thesis, so it's like we call it a mini thesis. And it will be evaluated by a evaluation panels consisting of representative of director or deputy director, a chairman, and also chairman of the postgraduate committee. We have 3 university staff, professor or associate professor, and also the principal supervisor and committee in the panel to evaluate. These are like kind of like the overview, so I'm not going into details. Please read the English versions. So your proposal, so your research proposal, PhD, will be evaluated, your mini thesis will be evaluated, and you will be presenting to the panel for like kind of like viva you can consider it as a viva. It will be harder than the actual master viva probably. But if you are found to be having the competency as a PhD, then you will be allowed to convert in the fourth semester. So you are registered as a PhD student in your fourth semester. Why I encourage to go through this route compared to the fast track PhD is that if you are doing fast track PhD, you directly register a PhD, you are paying higher tuition fee. In the past, fast track PhD, you don't have the chance of extension, but nowadays change already. You have the same as the PhD level, you can extend. So there's no such concern. The main disadvantage would be your tuition fee. You're paying more for 3 semesters. If you do conversion, you only pay master tuition fee for 3 semesters. You can save a lot, but then you get a PhD at the end. The only catch is that you have to complete your mini thesis, but thinking on the bright side, you're already halfway done your PhD thesis. If you've already done the master thesis, you're already halfway done your PhD thesis. So you're working on it anyway. So it's not a burden. You just need to sit through this panel evaluation. So that's the only catch for you to save all the tuition fee. So that's why I encourage people to go through conversion rather than fast track PhD for the first class students on undergraduate. And also I encourage the supervisors to take on this route for their student also, because you don't know the level of your students when they first enter from undergraduate. Especially for the past 2 years, MCO, our students, a lot of them don't have the practical skill in the lab. Everything is online, right? So you have to admit that. That's why we have this afternoon session and also the demo in like a few weeks' time or next week. Hands-on skill is very important in the lab. We don't want all the equipment to be spoiled by a new student. Okay, so now we move on to the supervision. Okay, there's a rules on the supervisory committee. Every student nowadays have at least 2 supervisor as a backup, just in case the main supervisor anything happen, quit, issue, health issue, anything, you have the backup from the same institute to take over as the main supervisor. So that's why even master student must have at least 2 supervisors from the same institute. That means you will be appointed a co-supervisor at least at the beginning. And there are more than 2 we also allow, but we would encourage that the supervisor to set only a maximum of 5, including themselves. So the total of 5 in the committee. Otherwise, the student will be burdened by too many supervisors' advices that they have to deal with. Okay, so that is kind of like an official recommendation from the postgraduate committee of Embassies to have a maximum of 5 supervisors only, rather than more than that. Okay. But otherwise, the postgraduate committee also have complication when every semester they have to ask the supervisor to fill in the progress report. So there will be too many semester progress evaluation if too many committee in the for the same students. Okay, there are rules as a main supervisor, and there shouldn't be family relationship or relative with the students. So that's the take-home message in this slide. The others, you can just read if you want to. And okay, so so this is for information of the supervisor, so not for the student, but just for your information. And that's why it's in Malay language only. The student don't need to know about this. So this was the supervisor information. So in terms of student evaluation, you need to know how you are evaluated. Okay. For the master, only the 6A is applicable to you. 6A refer to those research-based, research mode. So you will be evaluated by 1 internal examiner and 1 external examiner for your thesis. And that you have to produce a thesis and you have to go through the viva voce. Okay. So these are what you have to tick the box to get your master in the next 2 years for the new master student. You have to complete the 2 courses, the total 6 credits. So the one I keep mentioning, 6012 and 6014. You have to present your proposal as part of the 6014 in Malay language for local students. Whereas for the international student, you can present in English. Then every semester, you have to present the progress. So have this progress seminar every semester. And you will be evaluated by two evaluator and your supervisor on your progress. And as a master, you have to present at least a poster at a conference. You can present oral, that's the bonus. But at least one presentation, so that's a requirement at the conference, as a field related, so it can be national or international. And you have to publish one WOS index article, so not any article, but need to be indexed at WOS, Web of Science, not Scopus. Scopus only is not enough, so it need to be Web of Science. So you need to produce not more than 60,000 words. There's no minimum number of words, but there is the maximum. So your thesis cannot be too thick, not more than 60,000 words. And you have to sit through mock viva before your viva. Okay. So as for the PhD, there's a special case for some of the PhD if there's a staff of UKM under a teaching a scheme, they need additional external evaluator examiner, but in general also one external, one internal examiner. However, the requirement for the examiner will be at higher level, so they need to be like professor for a PhD probably. So the other general requirement, the difference is additional one more subject course called Big Data Analysis Biology 8022. It's offered in every second semester. And the other thing is two publications instead of one, and the thesis not more than 100,000 words. That's all the difference. And also the oral presentation, it must be oral presentation and ideally international conference. Okay. So for the international, this is what I mentioned about the Malay language. It might change, I'm not sure. So you do refer to the UKM SHAPE, you are from UKM SHAPE student, or later in the UKM briefing. So you have to enroll to some of these Malay language course. And the code might change already. So don't refer to this code, refer to the latest information. So this publication, previously is allowed for Scopus / WOS, but now only WOS. Okay. So if you are still student until second semester 2018-2019, this is still applicable to you. But for those that starting semester 1, 2019 onward, must be WOS. Okay. So this you can read, I'm not going to go through. Okay, this is a research progress. So every semester, if you haven't submit the thesis submission notice, then you have to present this, it's compulsory. So there's a deadline also. For those that don't want to present this anymore, you have to submit your thesis submission notice before, there's a deadline. This is a deadline for this coming semester. Put this down in your note for the student or the student. And also for new student, this is also a date for you to submit your proposal, which is January 27. You have to submit your progress report. Okay. Unless you have submitted your notice before 27 December. Because our seminar will be from the 7th to the 9th February. Okay. Also put this now in your calendar for all everyone, supervisor, students, everyone. Please block this date. 7th to 9th February, you must attend the seminar. And the deadline for submission of the report is 27 January. There will be penalty for those that late submission. Because previous semester, there's quite a few late submission. And the deadline for submission of the notice, submission notice, to be 27 December, so 1 month before. I don't take on those that is, like for example, 27 January want to submit the progress, only the week before submit the notice of the thesis submission. I don't take that, okay? You must, like it or not, you have to submit your progress report. If you don't submit your notice for the thesis submission by 27 December. Please bear that in mind. Okay? Get ready to write your report and submit it by 27 January. I already informed you well in advance so that you have time to write your report for this semester. This is from the previous semester online and the first ever hybrid physical. It was the previous semester too. Well done to everyone who have completed. And I'll also provide the form. You can look at this. This is a marking scheme. This is what your progress report should fulfill. Whether I have the English translation here also. So there are 70% accounted by written report and 30% by presentation. So the introduction needs to be comprehensive in the literature review, but not too long. You have to have the clear problem statement, rationale, hypothesis, clear and suitable objective, so research objective, and scope and limitation of study, please include that. Your methodology needs to be comprehensive and suitable and cited reference. Then all the research achievement should be provided. So can refer to this to how you write. There will be a template for writing the progress report and this will be presented during the RBRB 6014-8014. So you should learn about the progress report format. In your courses. Okay. So apart from that evaluation progress seminar, you're going to evaluate it by this LKC system. So it's every semester by your supervisor and co-supervisor in UKM. Okay, so you'll get a comment from supervisor. And this was the deadline from the previous semester, 21st August. So it's in Malay language, but I've translated into English for you to aware. Your supervisor is going to fill in about how often the frequency of meeting, your level of readings, your level of research, your thesis writing stage, and your competence in methodology, fundamental knowledge, attention to details, originality, language, and presentations, and others. So your motivation in your postgraduate study, thesis submission, whether you're ready or not, and overall performance, you're going to evaluate based on this. If you are underperformed or perform very poorly, you might be terminated. If you, like the whole semester, don't discuss your supervisor will put fail and terminated because you never see your supervisor or never discuss your supervisor, and that's the end. But you can appeal subject to consideration of the postgraduate committee. If you have four reminder, then you will be terminated also. You have two warning, also you will be terminated, and it's throughout. For example, you semester one, you get a reminder. Then the next semester, you get a pass, doesn't matter. But you get another reminder in your third semester, and then a warning on your fourth semester, then you will be terminated. Because you already cumulatively get two reminder and one warning. Okay, so bear that in mind. And refer to this in the handout that I send to everyone through WhatsApp. Also, it can be accessed on the website. Okay, so this is very critical. And also for supervisor, you have to bear this in mind. Whatever you have given to your student, please take note the previous semester. Don't suddenly, you already failed a student without you knowing that you have given them two warning, but not in a consecutive semester. And they will just be terminated. Okay, so this is very critical. So please see your supervisor frequently to discuss in your project. If you don't know or you underperform, you might need remedial and things like that. So you can defer your semester. Okay. So this is the responsibility of supervisor to evaluate your performance. And it is your responsibility to do the postgraduate study. It's not your supervisor do the research project for you. It's you learning to be a postgraduate researcher. Okay. So get your motivation and roles correct. You are not here to just to get a postgraduate degree certification. You have to work hard for it. Okay, there is no free certificate for you. You have to work hard to earn it because postgraduate is all about the skill acquired. It's unlike undergraduate. You get a scroll by sitting through exam, but not for PhD or master. For those that already have master and doing PhD now, you understand what I mean by that. But for those that just started master from undergraduate, you have to transition your mentality from undergraduate to postgraduate. It's very different. You can ask or consult your senior or your postgraduate friends. that the life is very different between an undergraduate and postgraduate. You might have the last minute assignment, but you want to complete your master thesis. It all depends on the hard work you put in all the time throughout the year, not last minute hard work. Okay. So how to GOT? So briefly, just go through for master. You can look through the timeline. If you want to GOT for master, you have to everything completed within the fifth semester. That means your notice should be submitted within the first month. That means this month, if you want to, if you are in your fifth semester, you want to GOT for a master, your notice should have been submitted within this month. Because you can only submit your thesis after 3 months of notice. That means you only left 2 months to go through the viva and correction. It doesn't guarantee that you submitted here, you will definitely GOT, because it depends on how major is your revision or your thesis. If you get a major revision and you extend beyond the fifth semester to correct your thesis for resubmission for approval for the Senate, you won't be semester 5, but you no need to pay for the registration for the sixth semester. That means you'll graduate in the sixth semester, not GOT, but you no need to pay for tuition fee. As long as you have submitted the thesis, you no need to pay for the semester fee. That's why a lot of students catching for the deadline to submit thesis. So remember that you have to submit the thesis before there's a deadline. If you look at the calendar that I show in the beginning, I think there might be a date that is written about the thesis here. Last date of thesis submission. Do you notice that? Some of you might overlook. This is the last date before, if you submit before 10 March, then you need to pay for the tuition fee. If you submit after this date, you have to register another semester and pay for another semester of tuition fee. Okay, so this is the deadline that everyone have to watch out for, especially for those in your sixth semester or master. Yeah, so if you are sixth semester, master, you don't want to pay for the seventh semester, please submit your thesis before 10th of March. If you want to submit your thesis before 10th of March, that means you have to submit your notice before December. Always work backward. Okay, begin with the end in mind. Hence, this is the important briefing for all new and returning students. Okay, all the date you have to put in your calendar. When is the deadline? These are the deadline you have to catch if you don't want to pay for semester. And for the PhD, similar concept. You'll go through all this research progress, publish all this. Okay, the catch to submit the notice is that you have to fulfill the publication in terms of submission. As long as you have proof that you have submitted 2 manuscripts, then you can submit your notice. If you don't have the proof that you have submitted manuscript, then sorry to say, you are not eligible to submit your thesis submission notice. Hence, there are some students actually still not yet submit. And as soon as they submit the notice, the supervisor have the responsibility to appoint the internal and external examiner through the postgraduate committee. You have to submit your abstract in Malay language and also English language. This is applicable to international students also. You have to have the Malay language abstract as well for your thesis, even though you are an international student. And you can find someone to help you or use your supervisor to help you. You have to submit UKM style. So all the thesis format, all those things will be, you will learn about it in the RBRB 6014 or 8014. Okay, you have to fulfill all the formatting, and the examiner CV, this one will be provided by a supervisor, also need to be in the correct format for the postgraduate committee to consider. Otherwise, the supervisor need to go back and forth with the committee. You have to follow exactly the guideline of the format of the CV. Don't simply send out the template and it come back in the wrong format and you just submit to the postgraduate committee. One knows Susanna going to send back to you and ask you to revise. It is supervisor responsibility to format the examiner's CV properly for the consideration of postgraduate committee and check properly the student thesis abstract. This is the main supervisor responsibility. Let me emphasize, main supervisor are responsible for appointing the examiner for the thesis, check the thesis properly, check the abstract properly, check the CV properly before submitting to the postgraduate committee for consideration. It's not the committee job to correct the abstract for the students. Please do your responsibility as a supervisor. And I've written here on the in the handout might be wrong, the number I corrected here already. Later I'm going to correct the handout. So basically you have to submit the extension at the end of sixth semester for master if you cannot complete. And for a PhD after 12th semester, the at least 1 month you have to submit. Okay, I think this is clear. And also I've given you some tentative timeline for thesis writing if you want to complete your graduate on time. Your first semester, you should complete your chapter 1 and 2 from your proposal. Semester 2, you should complete your methodology and some of your research objective ready for chapter 4. Semester 3, continue completing your chapter 4 in the research objective 2. And sem 4, complete everything, polish it up, and get the publication in your semester 5. Then you can sit for Viva and graduate within 5 semesters. This is a strategy. Or within semester 1-2, you can write the review article and publish already. You just need one. You can publish a review and you can eligible to submit thesis, also graduate. For the PhD, so I've given you some of the timeline you can follow. So this is just ideal. It doesn't work like that in science. It doesn't, that's why you have to work harder to compensate for the time lost in the failed experiment. So it's not a 9-to-5 job as a postgraduate. As you all will learn, it's a 24/7, you have to work hard to compensate for the procrastination that you made throughout your study. If you try to work this at the end, then you will suffer at the end and stress and burn out. And you're going to stress your supervisor at the same time. Okay, we don't want that to happen. Please work gradually every semester on the thesis. Then you can graduate on time. Don't put it until the last semester to write. Often the problem of students to graduate on time is the writing part, the writer's block. Okay, so to graduate on time, for many of you ask this question, is to start writing from the beginning. Work on your thesis from the beginning. Create all the different chapter, might not be in the guide UKM or UKM style first, but at least you have the material in all the chapter. You have to start with what you have already, you have the proposal, so you should be able to visualize what kind of result you should be getting, how you're going to interpret your result, and what you have to read a lot. In order to improve your writing, you have to read a lot. There is no shortcut to that. And yes, and guidance of supervisor also very important. So please, it's a teamwork between your supervisor and your student about how fast you can complete your thesis. If the supervisor is slow and you are slow, you are never GOT in terms of the correction of your thesis before submission. And for the fast track, this is what I mentioned. You have the difference between the PhD and the fast track is that within the second semester, there's actually a committee to look through whether you have perform as a PhD, otherwise you have to convert back to master if you doesn't achieve the level of a PhD in your first year. So the second semester, whoever in a fast track in your second semester now, prepare for this evaluation for your first year progress evaluation as a fast track. In the past, there is no extension allowed. If you seventh semester not yet finished, then that's the end. You don't even get a degree. Not even can convert to master. But now the guideline change already since 2019, you can extend under consideration. Okay? That's why in the past I discouraged to go through fast track. This is the danger in the past, but no more. Lucky for those that's the new one. Okay? And this is kind of like the evaluation, similar thing, but it's in BM, in Malay language. It's a similar like the evaluation form just now. It's just that whether it have performed as a PhD or not. Okay, and this is a small figure that you see down there here. So this is the big one. Basically, these are like the timeline from submission of thesis to viva. In between, there should be a mock viva. Okay, so in terms of thesis, preparation, all this. Oh, okay, this is what I mentioned. So I encourage all the international students to submit this form now. So first semester already submit for international students. For those that wish to write in English because of employer needs, please submit before the deadline. Okay? Otherwise, it will be very troublesome for me to bring it to the Senate level if you apply after 6th semester of PhD or 4th semester of master. So international student, please all fill in the form. You can consult Pano Susanna on, sorry, this one. So there's a form, permission to write English thesis in English. You just sign it, signed by your supervisor, and then submit to Pano Susanna. Okay. So this, I already talked through this. It can be excellent. Okay. When the examiner gives you excellent, then well done. You might get some award. Okay. So these are the criteria in English and BM. Okay. So in terms of plagiarism, main supervisor need to make sure the percentage of similarity score is not too long and there's no exact sentence that's copy-paste from the literature. Even if you copy-paste from your own publication, there will be complication or self-plagiarism. So be aware of that. That's why thesis compilation is a bit tricky. Okay. So please make sure supervisor have to make sure, because you have to sign the form. It's your responsibility to make sure there's no plagiarism of the thesis of your students. And this is in terms of the timeline. And okay, so you can read it yourself. And this is the checklist for the thesis submission, the abstract in Malay language, abstract in English, and also the proof of publication. In this case, proof of submission of manuscript is sufficient, but need to be 1 month prior to the progress report submission date. Yeah, don't submit this because you don't want to present your progress. And this is the form that you can refer to. Then this is a CV format that the supervisor needs to be aware of. And this form needs to fill in by the supervisor to nominate the examiner. And this is the form that I say that the examiner, the supervisor needs to sign about the plagiarism and justify if it's more than 30%. In this case, probably the compilation thesis will be. Okay, and these are the checklists when they submit thesis. So after you submit the notice, after 3 months, hopefully you have already completed the thesis. Then you want to submit your thesis. This is kind of like the all the requirement. I think you have to, last time you had to pay a certain fee. Now, I'm not sure. So you check with the treasurer. Okay, all these are the form. And this compilation thesis, so far we only have one student did that. It's Dr. Wan Aizat student. And it's complicated. So this one I have to discuss with your supervisor. If you produce a lot of publication. But there's a certain rules about it. Like, for example, for master, need to be more at least two publications and at least one is Q1 in the based on WOS rating, whereas the master need to at least four and at least two are in Q1. And also, I don't think the review count. I'm not sure. But you need to be a first author, okay? And need to be first evaluation by in UCAM. Okay, so all these are like the rules for a compilation thesis. But usually we just advise to go through the conventional. Sometimes it's even easier than have to go through the compilation. Because you still have to write the introduction in Malay language also. Okay, so this is the workflow for reference of supervisor. So not student, you can refer, but this is more on the management. On the administration of your examination so that you know what happened behind the scene. Okay, so there's a criteria for the examiner and this is for the supervisor to refer when they want to nominate, and there's an internal supervisor, internal examiner, and what happened in the oral examination, who are involved in the committee. So this is for your information only. You can read about this. Okay. And okay. I also provide even the examiner report. So examiner need to answer to this. So when you write your thesis, please make sure it tick all the box in here. That means you already have the research question, objective, all that fulfill what a master level or what a PhD level is about. You can ask advice from your supervisor. Okay. So you have to make sure your thesis answer to all these questions. Okay, whether you are entitled for a PhD or a master based on this report from the examiner. This is a guideline for the examiner, actually. It's very general. And the examiner is going to fill in this. After completing the report, they're going to tick the box. Either you are excellent, good, average, or poor. When you're poor, then we need we need more attention on your viva already. Okay. Alright, so all this I will just so this is a potential result from the after viva. If you are very good, you excellent, you might not need any correction, but usually it will be at least a minor corrections. Very, very minor will be less than 1 month. Some basic rewriting, I think probably around 3 months. So usually we get gives up to 6 months, probably for those that are working ready. But it's for those major up to 9 months. And those that need to be reviva is up to 12 months. And there could be some that fail and don't get at all. So this never happened in Brazil. We don't want to happen at Embarrassis. Okay, and this also not yet happened. We don't want it to happen also. But this has happened and is near the critical stage. Okay, so we hope that most of you will get this excellence. Okay, all the best. So work hard. And it's also supervisor responsibility also to make sure the thesis won't go to the fail stage. But ultimately, it's a student hard work. It's not supervisor job to write the thesis for you, okay? You have to work for it, and it's your thesis. It's not your supervisor thesis. He is just helping to guide you on the content and also check whether you've done correctly. And the language, grammar, you have the responsibility to make sure there is no typo, formatting, all correct. It's not your supervisor job to write thesis for you. Bear that in mind. Okay, so all this is just for reference. Okay, there's a maximum of up to 12 months for the first after appeal. Then the second round, 3 months only, the maximum given if you have the reviva. Otherwise, you will be failed and terminated. Okay, so this is like the, I highlighted the guideline. So it's like, you can apply up to one month only. That's if like given the 9 months you're not enough, you can write in writing to apply up until maximum 12 months only. That's all. There's no more longer, then you will be failed if you cannot revise your thesis in time. And there's a deadline. You have to write to the committee 2 weeks before the deadline given in the letter. You will get a letter after the viva on the deadline when you should submit your revised thesis to the examiner. And you have to cover a time that your supervisor needs to check it, your internal examiner needs to check it. And the deadline given is actually deadline on the hard copy, the final version, after even checking the format and also, yeah, all the things. Okay, I think we are running out of time. All this, just for your reference, you can just read it yourself. About final stage, you have to submit your hard copy thesis. Okay, the appeal, you have to pay the fine to get that. For example, get all this. In case it happened, you can do the appeal with the university. Okay, things like this happen. So this is an example. And you have to bring it to this, the Sichuan Academic Senate, the one I mentioned. Okay. And there are research misconduct. You can learn more in the courses like fabrication, forgery, plagiarism. All this will render you terminated. So it's a very serious offense in academic. Okay. So this is Symbiosis, all those introduced. And just to introduce the committee, it's not just me alone. There's a group of them. We have professor, we have associate professor, we have also senior lecturer. So we have different level of committee member, and the most important are the administration, Mr. Zai Li, and also Madam Guan Suzana. So she is the most important person that you have to deal with all the documentation. Okay, so you have to remember all these people. And okay, please follow the Facebook. Just now I think not yet introduced. Facebook Embassies UKM. For the new student, please follow all the latest what's happening at Embassies. Just follow the Facebook. And we have privilege, like the workshop introduced by the director just now. You are very privileged because you can join all the lecture from all the workshop organized at Embassies free of charge. And outside, they have to pay 100 or 1,000 to join the workshop. And when you have lots of workshop, especially this year and last year, that you can like join for free. Okay, and for the hands-on part, probably you have to pay, but for the lecture, actually you can join for free. That's the privilege being an Embassies student. Okay, we have plenty of activity. You can refer to the gallery. If you don't have access to Google, then it will be difficult because a lot of these photos are in Google Photo. So you have to probably use VPN or something to go against the firewall in China for those Chinese students. So welcome again to Embassies family. And also see you at the Research Progress Seminar, and you will get awarded just a encouragement. Even though it's just 50 ringgit Malaysia, but this year we add another electronic certificate. So just this is from the previous semester, and this semester just to announce, okay, I only will show the top three, mark. This is for the master. So these are the list of the master students presented. Okay, in terms of presentations, these are the top three students, and the winner is Faizato Atika. Badan. Okay, is she around? Anis, raise hand. Where is Faizato Atika? Is she in the room? Okay. Then we have the written report. Okay, the top is Noliana Izati. Well done. Okay, we have the poster for them. So this will be posted later by NJ Sharin. Okay. And then we have the PhD. And this mark is given by the two evaluator and also the supervisor. Okay, and you can see the mark is quite close, some of you, for the report. So don't give up for those that is like just one, like for example, Amni, you are very close. So work harder this time round. You might be the next winner for next semester. Okay, for the PhD, we have 15 PhD presented their progress in the semester 2021. Okay, so well done to Ching Ching. Okay, the only online presenter. The evaluator decided to give you the highest mark, so you win. Okay. But you can see Faris is doing very well. So well done, Faris, even though he's not here, the vice president of PSAI. And now we see the report. Okay. Report, the highest mark is won by Ting. Well done. Okay, but you can see also Faris also second runner up. So in a way, Faris is very excellent in both presentation and also report. So well done to him also. But unfortunately, it's just one mark different between the winner. So that's why I show the top three to show you all that actually some students are doing very, very well. Okay, it's very close actually between you all. So for those that don't get the highest mark, don't give up, so do better this semester. You all will get 50 ringgit. Claim from Anjet Zaili or Anjet Sharin. Okay, the poster will be posted also later on the Embassy's website. Okay, so apart from the semester, we also encourage, we give out this free money. You see, even though the two publication and the one publication is a requirement for it is a requirement for graduation, right? We still give money. If you at least you get 100 ringgit for your publication if you publish in Q4, because you need to publish anyway. Okay, as long as you are the first author and not yet get the Senate letter, when you publish, you get this award. If you publish in Q1, you get 250 ringgit. You publish Q2, you get 200 ringgit. So all this you can apply. Nowadays, it's not automatic. You have to apply if you want to get the award via the Google Form link. Okay, all this is on the website also. Later, I'm going to show you. So after you have published, you have to get it through your supervisor to register in the e-penerbitan. Then only you can apply for this reward. So it needs to be verified by the library first on the publication and your authorship. Okay, then you can apply for this award by filling in the Google form. Okay, congratulations to all the students. And embassy is running out of money. We don't know how long we can sustain this award. So apply while you can. Okay, so this is the form that you need to fill in. One publication, only one reward. That means if you have two person, only one person will get it and you can share the prize yourself. Okay, sometimes you have two first author of the same publication, but only one will be paid. Then you have to share the money yourself. Okay. We also have the award for GOT and excellent. If you graduate within 5 semesters or master, even though it's not counted in the Malaysia research excellent, we still encourage. So we still give money. If you graduate within 5 semesters getting the Senate letter, you can get 250 ringgit. If you achieve some publication excellence, you get even more, like 1,000 as an excellent for master. For a PhD, if you graduate on time within 7 semesters, you already have the 500 ringgit. And if you achieve the excellent criteria, you get 1,500 ringgit. And this should be applied within 1 month before convocation. Our convocation is 1 December. Previously was 30th November. So you have until 1st November as a deadline to submit. Okay? And for the excellence, only like master, you need 2 publications. Or 1 Q1, then you consider as GOT excellent. If PhD, you have 2 publications and one of them is Q1, then it's considered excellent. Okay, so who is eligible can apply on this Google form. Also not automatic, you have to apply. So if you yet to get the Senate, should we have the Senate letter, but if not in time for the deadline, please inform us. So far, there's only one candidate for this year. Well done, Haswan. You are lucky. You are considered as GOT by the Senate. So you can apply. Okay. Please apply. If you don't apply, you don't get the money. Okay. So master, there is no GOT. So PhD, there is one. Potentially get the 1,500. So embassy is 1,500 poorer. So please apply. Otherwise, you won't get it for the coming convocation, which is in the morning session, 1st December. Okay, apart from that, at the UC level also, there is this excellent award. So you have to look out for it. It's not every year, for sure, but then possibly you have to look out for it. That this one from the past year, that even for the Muslim student, there's the Pusat Zakat, you can also offer some incentive. For those that publication also, they get out a lot of money. For the Zakat, you can get like 1,000 ringgit for Q1 publication. So for the Muslim student, please apply, okay, for those that eligible, okay. And there's also scholarship or you can Zakat scholarship. I don't think it's open yet this semester, but there are some of these scholarship. The criteria is quite difficult, okay. So and the guideline is in Malay language, so those international students might have to use Google Translator. But it's quite important touch to get the scholarship. So if you eligible, please apply. But you get a lot of money, 3,200 per month stipend. Or if it's the Basel Para, you get 2,000. And nowadays the Zamala only given to the new student of first semester, I think. only for first semester. Okay, that's unfortunate. For the returning student, there is no like skip the scholarship for you. Okay, you have to be rely on the GRA from the research grant. For the those graduate, there's also this award called MTDC Innovation Award. So you can look at the criteria. Okay, this is for 2022. And there's also a certain number of semester criteria. And then, you have to compete with other in the university, not just in BioSys. Okay, and this one already passed, too bad. Otherwise, can enter. But however, don't look at it as too difficult. There is also how you strategize. For those new student or the relatively young student, you can still strategize to get this award. There's a lot. As a PhD, you get 1,000 worth of gold and 5,000 cash. As a master, you get 1,000 worth of gold and also 2,500 cash. And this year, there is no candidate from social science, actually. There's quite a few master from the pure science. And to earn this award, it's not just publishing and also research. You have to earn some award, for example, presenting at conference, international conference. At different level, it's different mark. And also innovation award, patent, all those counting toward criteria. So you can look at the form. Okay, I also uploaded this in the Google Drive. You can have a look. And this is kind of like the scheme for the science and technology. So you can see if GOT, you get certain kind of mark. If you publish, you get certain kind of mark. There's a cap for the mark. So don't worry if you don't achieve like 13 publication, like the candidate from the engineering department, you still are possible to earn it. Don't think of like other candidate that publish 15 paper within their PhD or within their master will surely win. Not necessarily, because there's a cap in publication. It's just one aspect of it. Like when you present overseas as an invited speaker or just presenting as a poster, you get certain mark also. And innovation, whether you have patent approved or patent filed, also different kind of mark. And you join any competition, all this counting towards it, and you get a total of 105 marks, I think. So you can try to strategize. For those in the committee or PSAI, also is counted. So if you organize event like IPS Bio 3, that's considered international event. So you are considered as this, the international level. If you are Pengarah, Demam Pengarah, all these counting 70 marks. So you can score here as the PSAI or the activity. So please take on the role and then earn this mark here to get the award. Okay, so for master, there's no GOT. Its total is 100 marks, so you can strategize also. Okay, so you can join this kind of 3-minute thesis competition. You can see it's one of the criteria also. If you get until international level, you get 40 marks. Okay, so join all this. We have last night alumni win it before. Then we are proud of our student, PhD student, and is very active in extracurricular activity. Can get travel grant also counted. You can get prizes at the conference, like this is from our IRCSB. And all counter, you can go for the research attachment, and this is funded by the university there. So we have student visiting Japan for a few weeks or month, and we have student one semester in Chulalongkorn University in Thailand. So these are opportunities you can seize, not just in embassies, but going international. How are you going to promote yourself or market yourself as a postgraduate, excellent postgraduate, not just any postgraduate, you by adding this kind of excellent element to your study, not just completing your degree. Okay, join the society, please. Join the society. Okay, there is also TikTok, I think. All this branding kind of things is important. Okay, so I think something wrong with the website previously. Okay, so the PSLIP look into it. And I think this one is upcoming. All this is presented. This is upcoming, the iNow. IREX will be postponed to 2023 early next year. So please get involved. follow the Facebook page of PSAI UKM. All the event, all the contribution had to be recorded in iStar, even though the postgraduate not yet compulsory to rely on iStar to count for the score. You then have to provide supporting document, but I encourage you to have this in your record. And remember, the sky is the limit beyond UKM, beyond Imbiosis. You have to do the best to seize opportunity from whatever sources you can, especially for the international student. You can actually get opportunity within China, I think, India also. Try your best. And also, try to do your best for everything that you do today. Then you won't have regret. Set your goal and work hard every time, like the ends. You notice the ends. And hopefully you can graduate on time. And it might be difficult for you to tackle and juggle everything as a postgraduate. That's why we have this workshop. Try to provide some tools for you. It will be on the 3rd November, conducted by Associate Professor Dr. Sharunata Kai, Dr. Nohaida, and me. So for more info about that, you can go to our website. Okay, this is the campus. It's a beautiful campus. Don't just hide at Imbiosis. Go out and explore the campus. Go beyond Imbiosis. Go explore UKM when you come to UKM, for those that yet to come to UKM. And have a great time here. Maximize your potential. Okay, you can get, you all are in the WhatsApp group. So anything, just contact through there or ask through there. Okay. So we'll see you here at the convocation. This is the hall for the convocations. And the end is the start of the new beginning, especially for those master students. Okay? It's not the end of the journey yet. Okay? And at the end of PhD also is the start of new career. This is what I mean. Okay, I think that's all from me. Any questions from the student? If not, we can go through the Kahoot first. Just a short Kahoot. I'm actually extending a standard time already. Now it's already 12:30. Hopefully we'll end before 12:50. So for the new student, please join the Kahoot quiz. Hopefully China can access. Okay, so to join the Kahoot quiz. Because there's a limit here on the free one, can only 10 participants, so I can only allow the new student to join. There will be prizes at the end for the new student who win it. Okay, so the new student, please join Kahoot. You just go to it, it will come out the pin. But there are, I think, 12 of you. We can only allow 10. So not sure whoever can join first then can play. Okay, go to Kahoot It, www.kahootit, and put in this pin. So the new student join, please. The other student can listen. And refresh whether you get it right or not. Like all the new students, please join. And the returning student can be the spectator. Meng Jiao, can China access this URL? Are you still here?
I'm trying to into it. Please okay. Wait.
Then already, Dr. Go.
Only 10 ready. Oh, okay. Yeah. Sorry to those that cannot join. Then we'll start. Okay, get your phone ready. We'll start. Okay, those that cannot join, it's okay. Just listen and check your understanding. You can choose the answer yourself. Okay, who is the chairperson of Postgraduate Management Committee?
Hello, Professor. I am into the web, but what is the PIN code?
Sorry, you cannot join already because we already reached the limit, 10 player. So no worry, you just listen to the quizzes and try to pick the answer yourself. But how come only two managed to answer in time? Too slow? You have to be faster, yeah? And some get it wrong. Chairperson is the deputy director. Both of you get it wrong. Okay? You are not listening. Next question. This is a very hard question. Probably you don't know. Who is doing the auditing? So if audit, will be referring to what? It'll be quality management. So who is the in charge of quality management? Okay, well done. It's the head of quality assurance, Dr. Kamaru Azlan. Yeah. So, not the director, yeah. Okay, next question. We'll try to be faster. Okay, I keep mentioning her name just now. The trick is her. Okay, everyone got it right, thankfully. Okay. Who coordinate postgraduate activity? Is the supervisor of some of you? It's Dr. Noor Halida. He's a coordinator of postgraduate. Not me. I coordinate postgraduate program, not activities. UKA is on the rise. Okay, now this is another trick. Who coordinate Inbiosis facility and infrastructure? You will listen to him later in this afternoon. One more question, one more, please answer. Yes, it's Associate Professor Dr. Ng Chan Leong, the head of Seagate and CPB. Okay, CBR also in charge of advice, mainly on biomatic. Okay, Dr. Low is the lab manager, but the whole the facility and infrastructure actually is the head of center. This is another trick. Who should you see to get the access card? Only some of you have already got access card notice. Hopefully you'll know them in person when you come to Inbiosis and working in the lab. Actually, returning students also don't know this answer. It's Mr. Muhammad Faros. He's in charge of all the access card. Okay. Now more on the postgraduate regulation. If you want to GOT for master, you should submit your thesis 2 months before the end of which semester? Not the third semester, yeah? That's too early. You have to have minimum 4 semesters. So you will submit your thesis by the end of 5th semester. You cannot submit thesis 2nd and 3rd semester. 3rd semester is for conversion to PhD. Okay. Well done, Tay. Next. If you want to JOT for PhD, you shouldn't submit your thesis after. So choose day when it's already beyond GOT or not going to make it for GOT. What how many months is GOT? Just calculate backward. How many months is 7 semester? Yeah, the answer is 40 months. You have to submit your thesis before the 40th month, because you have to submit 2 months before end of semester, which is 42 months for 7 semester. Okay? You must apply for conversion to PhD in writing before the 7th week of the 3rd semester. How many months is that? The 7th week of the 3rd semester. You can just find the closer answer. It's 13.75 months. The 3rd week of the 3rd semester, so 2 semester is 12 months, right? So it's definitely more than 12 already. So it will be 13.75. That would be the fast answer. Okay, the following are required for master graduation, except so for the, okay, so most of you correct, you have to definitely complete 6 credit for a master. Okay. Oh. So SS on the rise. When does a full-time master student need to apply for extension? The answer already like is on the screen. The answer is end of 6th semester. You have to apply for extension already. Okay, this is the registered semester. When you defer, it doesn't count as the registered semester. So you have to remember that. So at the end of registered 6th semester. Wow, CMZ on the rise, overtaking day. When a full-time PhD student need to apply for extension? Answer is also on the screen if you forgot what I've told you. Still some, only one get it right. Extension, strictly speaking, is after the 12th semester, but after 8th semester, it won't be GOT ready. So you have to apply extension for PhD after 12th semester. So you have a long time before you need to apply for some extension. Only one get it right. So are you listening to my briefing just now? What is the maximum registered semester for a full-time master student? Remember, there's the opportunity to extend. So this is including the extension. So including the 4 extension, you have a total of 10 semester. So the answer is 10 semester. Okay. The answer won't be 8 semester because 6 plus 4 is 10. So you have to think. If you really know, then you can answer those questions. I put it as a higher level question so that you get it wrong and you will remember forever. Which year is the latest UCAM graduate regulation? It's in the book just now. Yeah, it's 2021, yeah, the latest version. There might be a new one, I'm not sure. But not in 2022. Okay, SS is now number one. The following are covered in UCAM regulation, except, remember I showed you the list just now. These are guidelines that are not covered in the regulation. So the answer would be, all clue is given. For those that forgotten, please refer back to my handout. I'm going to update the PDF later. Later I'm going to send the latest PDF to Wan Intan to upload. They are all covered except compilation thesis. The question is asking what is not covered. Compilation thesis is covered by guideline, not in the regulation. Please download and read the regulation. Yeah, you need to know that. Not just me knowing it, you yourself to know that. Don't argue with me later because you don't read it. I already told you all about the regulation today. All will result in termination except another trick question. Because the answer is all will be terminated. If you get fail terminated, definitely. 3 reminder, 1 warning terminated, 2 warning terminated. So make sure your LKC is always passed. So your supervisor is important in determining whether you will continue a semester. This to apply thesis, just like I say already, master within before 4 semester, PhD before the 6 semester. But international student, please apply now. Submit the form. It's in Word file. You can contact Pano Susanna and fill in the form. The answer is 6 semester for PhD and 4 semester for master. Which of the following is true? Then I say maximum, not minimum. PhD, how many maximum? Master, PhD, how many maximum? The answer is maximum PhD, 100,000 words. Okay. Close. Sha is chatting up. Who is responsible to ensure no plagiarism of thesis? Actually, the student themselves cannot plagiarize, but someone has to do something to make sure it's really the case. Who is the person that I emphasize again and again? Yes. I'm glad. You all get it right. Okay. You should submit the thesis submission notice, except you have to submit before mock viva. You cannot have mock viva or viva if you don't submit the notice. Wow, Sha is number one. When is mock viva needed? The answer is before viva. As simple as that. It is true also after thesis submission notice, but it's not true because you have to submit thesis. It's not enough if you just submit thesis submission notice. You have to submit thesis, then only you can have mock viva before viva. Wow. The following are requirements for compilation thesis, except this one also emphasized as now. Master need 2 WOS, 1 Q1. PhD need 4 WOS, 1 Q1, 2 Q1. And now I think review cannot consider as one of them. So you can must be the first affiliation. You can have QCAN as the second affiliation to count as the paper. What is the maximum time to revise thesis for the first time? This one also, I think I mentioned. This include apply to extend. So it's 12 months maximum. Definitely not 3 months. This is maximum time. Actually, it's 11 months for those that don't need revival. But another 1 month is to apply if you cannot make it. what's the maximum time to revise for the second viva? This is second viva. Just now, someone I think answered for the second viva. Time's up. Answer is 3 months. We don't want second viva in biosis. It never happened and we don't want it to happen, hopefully. So please do a good job in writing your thesis. Last question. What's the maximum time to fulfill your publication after thesis submission? The answer is you have 1 year to get your publication accepted, not submission, accepted to get the standard letter. You need to get at least 1 for master and at least 2 for PhD publication accepted to graduate with standard letter. So we see the winner. Number 3, SY. Number 2, SHA. Number 1, SS, is it? Well done. You can come and claim the prize from me. Come to my office. Don't despair, Tay and CMZ. And all other students, I think you will feel that it's tricky also, right? You might get it wrong yourself. I hope those that get it wrong, you will remember what's wrong. And you will remember the correct answer forever during your study at Imbalsis. I think that's all from me. Before we end, let's just close this and come back to this again. If you have any question, probably you can ask now. I can go to this poll EV again. What have you learned today? Can you answer? I think most of you are hungry already. Just faster go through this. Hopefully, or even the returning student learn something or the supervisor learn something today. We keep repeating this every semester, but I hope there is a good reminder this semester also for everyone at Imbalsis. When I'm doing this presentation slide also, I learn something. Because the guidelines sometimes get updated, regulation get updated, I have to keep updated, and the slide also need to be updated. Okay. Regulation for postgrad, lots of deadline. This is true. One important thing as a postgraduate or be systematic is having calendar, having timeline. Like the timeline given for the GOT, right? You should print out and paste it on the wall or on in front of your bench so that you know when's the deadline. Which year, what month you have to submit your thesis. Even you are just registering now for master or PhD, you can work in advance. When is the deadline you have to submit your notice, when you have to submit your thesis, and then work backward on the chapter you need to be completed. Okay, so begin with the end in mind as one of the effective habits. Okay, I'll keep mentioning that again. And about how to be an effective researcher in the workshop on the 3rd November. So there are some tools that you can use to balance between your postgraduate study and also your personal life. Being a postgraduate doesn't mean you have to sacrifice all your personal life. Even though to some of you might be as stressful as that, but that depends on individual capability. How much you want to work hard determine how fast you can graduate. You can graduate excellent, or you can graduate slowly because you procrastinate or because you're just unlucky that the project doesn't work out. So this largely depends a lot on luck. You need luck for your experiment, you need luck for your publication, and you need luck for your examination. Okay, glad you all learned a lot. Okay, so let's see if any question, Q&A. So you can ask any question, type in your questions, and hopefully I can answer. So for those eligible for the publication reward or the graduation reward, please apply before deadline. You never ask, you never get, you never apply, also you never get. For the supervisor also, they have a award for the publication, also need to apply. It's not by default. Everything you want to get, you have to work hard for it. So that's the first lesson. You have to remember and appreciate the grant, research grant that's acquired by your supervisor. Otherwise, you wouldn't be able to do the postgraduate research. Because there's money to do the project, then only you are hired as the student. So you are lucky that there's a research grant, then you can become a postgraduate student at Embassies. Okay, so between you and your supervisor is beyond just supervisory role. You have to remember that you also tie up to the research grant outcome. So there's a balance here. The supervisor has to take note. The research grant and the postgraduate program, even though the causal to be, there's a postgraduate program for that student because of research grant, doesn't mean that the student have to fulfill all the objective in the research grant. The research grant might be a scope of a PhD rather than a master. So you have to really look into that. Even the times for the student might be enough already, or the scope enough already as a master, you have to balance what you expect from the student to let the student graduate, even though you not yet achieve all the KPI from the grant. So that the supervisor have to bear in mind. If you have issue with your supervisor, there is actually a committee. We have the unit bimbingan in Biosis. Last time we call it UBI. There are some committee, but any issue can raise up to the postgraduate committee, and we will bring the issue to that specific non-supervisor committee for advice. So the ratio of student enrolled, student graduated, student drop out. Okay, this we don't have it yet. What do you mean by ratio? Or you want the numbers, is it? Just now I already mentioned the student enrolled and student graduated. You can refer back to the slide. Student dropout, there's quite a few, but not in the record. There's various reasons student drop out, probably financial reason, also project reason, the cannot write, also another issue. So you must remember you have responsibility to complete your postgraduate. Otherwise, your supervisor will suffer. They need to produce postgraduate as an outcome of the research grant. If you quit at the end, that means they wouldn't have enough time to have another student, and they will be blacklisted for future research grant application. So that is a consequence beyond just yourself, that you wasted your time, money, and the supervisor wasted opportunity for another student to take on the position. If you feel that you are not suitable as a postgraduate researcher, please quit now. Don't wait until the third or fourth semester to realize you are not suitable as a postgraduate, as a researcher. You don't want to be a scientist. You don't want to be a researcher. You don't want to learn all about technical skill. You hate it. Don't do it at the end. Do it now. Quit as soon as possible so that your supervisor have enough opportunity to hire a new student to achieve the outcome of the research grant. Don't quit at the end. You have responsibility with your supervisor, and this should be discussed between you and your supervisor on what is required or expected of you, not just the postgraduate program. I'm just in charge of the postgraduate program, but the research outcome, that one is between you and your supervisor. Then you have to manage the relationship with your supervisor and the expectation between you two. Okay. Can I still apply your application form on writing thesis in English if I master that has already surpassed? I'm having international what? International co-supervisor. No. If you want to go, if you want to submit now, I have to bring to the Senate. I wouldn't want that. Okay, it's very troublesome. So this should be informed to you already. Okay, this is in the regulation. You should know this already before now. If you are already beyond four semester, only you realize it, it's too late. So me as a chairperson, I wouldn't approve. And also UCAM rules is as a local student, you are supposed to write in Malay language. You are not an international student. Even though you have an international supervisor, okay, that is not one of the compulsory. It's up to me to decide whether you're eligible or not, if you want to justify about that. Okay, so in this case, I don't allow. So please write in Malay language. Is there any Chinese? No, there is no Chinese PhD, so you are the first. Hopefully, you'll be the first. At least for embassies. But at UCAM level, yeah, there are plenty of Chinese PhD. Regulation, what you want to know about regulation? What are the requirements for best presenter, best writing? The requirement is become the best. That's why it's called the best. If you get the highest score, then you'll be the best presenter or best written report. And I already give you the marking. So if you achieve all at the excellent level, then you could have the highest score and you become the best presenter or best written report. So just do your best in your submission on the progress. Okay, so just refer to the marking scheme. Any assistant offer? Okay, this one answered already. Any semester deduction due to pandemic? Oh, this one. This one I think is very informed by Dr. Ayn previously. You have to apply for that. It's not by default. And there's a consideration of GRA. Okay. And the semester is counted based on number of registered semester. And you can refer to Puano Susanna for your latest number of registered semester. Or Mr. Zaili, who have got access to your record. And your supervisor also have record of how many number of semester you registered. So you yourself should know better how many semester you registered. Don't rely on others to know this. You should know better how many semester you register or how many semester you defer and what semester are you in now. Yeah, okay. You should be independent. You're learning to be independent researcher at Embassies. So especially for the PhD student. So you should be taking accountability for your postgraduate study. Don't rely on your supervisor. You are not being spoon-fed here. That's the difference between a postgraduate and undergraduate. Okay. If there is no other questions, I think that's all from me. Sorry for taking 1 hour extra. I think if no other question, that's all. And thank you for staying with me and enjoy your lunch before we come back again for our afternoon briefing with Associate Professor Dr. Ng Chan Leong. Okay, that's all from me. Thank you, everyone. Okay.
Thank you, Dr. Goh.
Can stop recording. Okay, thank you, Dr. Harita. I'll pass back to you.
All right, thank you very much. Thank you very much, Dr. Goh, for the comprehensive briefing. So now we will have a short break until 2 p.m. To all the students and fellows, please come back again at 2 p.m. where we have briefing with Dr. Ng Chan Leong. All right, see you later. Bye.